in harm's way because of some weather we've been dealing with across the southeast right now, so we send prayers out to you. But we're enjoying a wonderful, gorgeous fall night. And how about that great collection of fans who've gathered here and getting ready for, I think, as fun a game as we may have all year long. Rusty.
Standing room only right here. You knew it was going to be that way tonight. Carrollton-Rome has kind of grown into that rivalry. The Northwest Georgia, this is that game that everybody talks about, two heavyweights. Obviously, Carrollton played for the 7A state championship last year. Rome goes to the semifinals. Ironically, both teams' last loss was to, as you mentioned, the 6A Stamps champs, Langston Hughes.
And, of course, these two teams have been playing each other, you know, especially prior to Carrollton moving to the 7A classification for years. Carrollton did beat Rome in a regular season matchup, and John Reed told us this week, hey, historically, especially dating back to 2016 when this Rome program really got cooking under John Reed, the winner of the game between these two teams has a history and a tendency to travel a long way in the postseason. You will see our kick, and we are underway. Barron Stadium in Rome, Georgia, and getting a chance to return it 10, 15, 20, sideline, 28-yard line there. Getting things going is Nick Hester.
Nick Hester right there on the return for Rome. And may I tell you what, Brandon, he had some space. Had he not tripped up?
He absolutely did. Had some space right there. And so that's going to bring Rome out here on offense. A chance to see Reese Fountain, a quarterback, presented by the Georgia Army National Guard. So Fountain, how about 29-5 historically as a starter.
Yep.
This is a guy who's won a lot of games in giving John Reed what he's had a lot of, which are veteran quarterbacks, multi-year starters.
What did he say? He's had three quarterbacks in 9 years?
That's exactly right.
It's crazy.
It's a handoff, a running play on first down, and not much doing there. There to meet him was Quintus Adams, the outside linebacker, senior outside linebacker, who's there to make that stop. And that'll give us a chance to see the Carrollton defense. Once again, brought to you by the Georgia Army National Guard. Two returning starters there on the defensive front for Carrollton. And obviously one of the guys to look at there in the middle, terrific linebacker Montrez Smith. That's a Duke commit. We'll be seeing him a lot tonight as Fountain is throwing, and that's complete. Getting D.K. Daniel involved in the offense for the first time tonight.
Yeah, Joey King said this is like guarding Tennessee's offense. They want to spread you out, create numbers in the box, and you got to tackle in space. He said, look, these wide receivers from Rome aren't the biggest guys we face for them, but, man, they are twitching. He knows they got to tackle these guys when they get the ball out on the perimeter.
Moving fast here, third down coming up. That's the handoff. It's Arthur, and once again, this Carrollton defensive front is there to meet him, and they force fourth down, and how about that? That's Jacob Levy, a national champion wrestler, one of the defensive linemen who leads the charge.
Yeah, 16 and under national champ. He goes out to Fargo, North Dakota, and absolutely goes undefeated to win the national championship. So you think that young man doesn't know anything about leverage? Big time anchor in the middle.
So it's a high
punt. They came after it first.
They came after it. Going to bounce and now take a Rome roll inside the 25-yard line. So good field position there after the flip of the field, and that's going to give us a chance for the very first time tonight to see Julian Juju Lewis, a sophomore quarterback for Carrollton, a USC commit, freshly newly minted within the last couple of weeks, and a guy that ESPN has ranked the number one recruit in all of football, regardless of year. You see Lewis there. Of course, one of the big stories for Carrollton is who you don't see right now, the terrific running back and pass-catching back out of the backfield, Bryce Hicks, who was injured in that Langston Hughes game week one. They have bounced back pretty well after the Hicks injury. And obviously one of the guys you see that's allowed them to do that, that's Kamari Farmer, the running back, who we'll see kind of filling the void that was left behind by the Hicks injury.
Both coaches felt like they had to run the ball tonight to win this game, and you look at the Rome defense.
Yeah, that's the Rome defense. Once again, brought to you by the Georgia Army National Guard. I want you to keep your eye on number 98, but it's Justin Terrell. That's a guy on his way to NC State, but also lining up next to him, Trey Adams, the defensive end. Pound for pound, he may be the best athlete on this team. Yeah. He had a sack in our Corky Kell Dave Hunter Classic game, the win for Rome against Cass. As you see, Lewis out quick with the pass and the completion and a third down coming up.
Yeah, Rome had a third and one, unable to convert. You see Juju, this is a nice pitch and catch for him. So he easy gets the ball out there. Rome knows they got to bend but not break. Big third and three right here early on.
Seventh catch of the season that time for Ryan Mosley, by the way. Third and two here. Julian Lewis, the shotgun. Going to give the handoff, and it's first down yardage and more. Plenty of room to run. Almost up to midfield that time goes Kamari Farmer, the sophomore running back.
Joey King spoke highly of him. Look, he's not going to dance around the absence of Bryce Hicks, one of the best players in the state. But he said, look, we got a young one right here. This is the next one. And now he's been put into the lineup because of that injury.
You see the numbers for him on the year, already six rushing touchdowns for this prolific offense. And every one of those matter, as we said before, because Hicks, had he not gotten injured, would have been the most one of the most important players in the entire state. And he was a year ago for Carrollton as well.
He is electric, dangerous with his. It's like John Reed said about him, he can play every single position on the field outside the inside the box.
Juju handoff again, but this time Rome is there to meet him. Parko Smith, the linebacker, one of the guys in on that stop. Smith is a guy that John Reed, the Rome coach, told us, hey, he's ready as a linebacker for him to really kind of break out in a big way, and expects that could happen. They're going to rotate a lot at linebacker tonight around Jaden Harmon, who's obviously a big-time prospect. They're going to rotate a linebacker, and Parko's one of those guys they're going to be leaning on there, too. You pick up a yard, and now you're looking at second nine. In motion goes the tight end. Now Juju going to throw. Strike. Right there, 37-yard line there to haul it in was Ryan Mosley. Second catch of the night for Mosley.
Yeah, that's another sophomore wide receiver. You're going to see number one right there. This is not – you get plenty of time right here. And you see the delivery. See how tight that ball is. Good job there by the Carrollton wide receiver, Mosley, going up and getting it.
How about the numbers so far on the year for Juju Lewis, 66% completion, 427 yards, has four touchdowns, still has not thrown a pick. Big battle in week one between him and obviously Aaron Nolan on his way to Ohio State.
Blitz.
Lewis going to try to elude the rush. Now going to dance around and try to get rid of it. It's going to fall incomplete. Trey Adams, who we told you about earlier, one of the guys who had pass pressure that time, and Lewis had to use his feet to give himself some time.
They also brought Jaden Harmon, the four-star junior linebacker, number one, right there. You see him flush him and watch him come back in and force this throw. You're going to see number one, Jaden Harmon. He has offers from Tennessee, Michigan, Mississippi State, and Duke, among others, early on.
Looking now at second down. Juju going to hand it off again, and there to meet him is Trey Adams. Rome active in the backfield. That's going to lose yardage.
I told Coach Reed on our teleconference this week, I didn't know much about Trayvon Adams, but I'm telling you right now, number 48, he wears, you see that beware of the dog on his back? That's a dog. 48 has been a monster for anybody that's played Rome so far this year.
What is it, the popular meme? He tested positive for having that dog in him?
He's got the dog in him. 6'2", 250-pound defensive end, and saw these guys against Cass, and he was a problem for Cass. They dealt with him all night long from that defensive end position.
Third and 12. Keep your eye on number 7. That's Caleb Odom for Carrollton. That's an Alabama commit. Look out for number 7. He'll be in the middle here. Juju going to throw. Tight end. The target. Not able to connect that time with Jordan White. And Rome has forced a fourth down.
Big stop right there for the Rome defense. They had it first down in their territory on their side of the field. You're going to see number 22, Joseph Wilkinson, the senior defensive back. Appalachian State commit all over the field, number 22 for them. And interesting, Brandon, when you get a chance to talk about it, Carrollton came after the first punt. That's something you see on tape. They came after the first one of the night and almost got it.
John Reed told us a lot this week that he has great respect for Carrollton on special teams. He says this is not the kind of team you can play a lot of games or have any kind of problems with on special teams. They're sharp there. How about this high punt? Going to bounce inside the 10. Then is it saved? Did Carrollton get that? They're going to say no. They're going to say touchback.
They almost got
it. Good high punt that time by the Carrollton punter, Andrew Albertus. And now Rome gets a stop, gets the football back. Second possession of the game coming up. We've still got no score. Just underway. Barron Stadium, Rome, Georgia.
America, it's time to gear up and get out there in a new Ford vehicle. And it all starts at your local Ford dealer during the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need to discover your best summer ever. With a large inventory in stock, now is the best time to trade in, trade up, and discover summer with Ford. Now get 2.9% financing for 60 months plus up to $4,500 cash back on select Ford SUVs. See your local Ford dealer and discover your best summer ever. Link your Ingalls Advantage card to your child's school, giving the advantage to those who really need it. That's our pledge to you.
Under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You don't have to wake up on the right side of the bed to know how you like your coffee, as long as it's McCafe coffee from Mickey D's. Now that's what you like.
Mix and match two breakfast hits for $4.49. Add any size iced coffee for $1.79. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Turn right onto Western Avenue. You've reached your destination.
One more.
One more time.
ID Light in the all-electric ID4. It's the little things. Lease the 2023 all-electric ID4 Pro for just $3.19 a month after an EV lease bonus and customer bonus.
And welcome back. No score and a pretty fast pace here to get things going. Carrollton traveling up to take on the Rome Wolves. Carrollton top 10 team ranked in the 7A classification. Rome top 10 in the 6A classification. Great rivalry over the years. And another renewal of this series here tonight. You see, back at quarterback once again is Reese Fountain. Big night for him in the previous game we had on TV for him. As he's going to throw, and it's going to be complete, and that's Hester again. How about nine catches for Hester? Hester in the win against Cass in the Corky Kell Dave Hunter Classic, and on this first down reception, he moves the chains again, gets the ball up across the 40. Pickup of 21 that time for Hester.
That's what worried Joey King the most. He said, these wide receivers out in space with some speed, you miss a tackle, and you give up 21 because of it.
Fountain takes the snap, going to throw to Hester again, this time incomplete. There to shut him down was Cameron McClure, the junior cornerback. Good coverage from McClure.
I talked to John Reed before the game, and he said, look, we don't think that Carrollton's going to sit back and let us do a lot of that tonight. And you see Carrollton flashing there early on those bubbles.
Yeah, it's interesting. Joey King kind of compared this Rome offense a little bit to Tennessee because they throw underneath and try to get the ball out quick as you see D.K. Daniel.
Got a late hit, I believe, on the quarterback as well.
So we may tack on more yards to the reception by Daniel. Daniel might be pound for pound the most explosive of these Rome receivers.
Yeah, they love him. A lot of connection between he and Reese Fountain. Known each other for a couple years now. Played together all the way up through, I think, sixth grade. So those two are throwing it around a little bit together.
You see our officials. We'll hear from our referee, Jeff Jathro.
Dropping the passer on the defense. 15 yards added to the end of the run. First down.
Of course, officials presented here by the Georgia Sheet Metal Air Conditioning Contractors National Association. Gary Richards is our field judge. Philip Tucker is our electronic clock operator. Ron Baird, also part of this great crew there, too. Had a chance to bump into a few of those guys before the game today.
They were excited about that.
Enjoying a nice meal here in the Rome area prior to the game. So, always fun to see.
I'm going to take you to a good restaurant.
Oh, yeah, listen, if we're playing, we're going to have some good food, hopefully.
See that? They're showing good block there by Daniel. And look,
there's Hester again. Second catch for him. He moves the chains again. And if Daniel's the most explosive, Hester may be the most dependable.
That's right. And so you look, they go two on two, basically. Watch number three pin his guy. So this is only a one-yard pass. It, really, Daniel's blocking. He blocked his defensive back all the way through the sideline.
There's Chance Arthur, the running back now. He's going to get the ball to the 20. May have gotten five that time. That's the other element of this offense. And John Reed said, we have to have Chance Arthur have a big game for us tonight.
Yes. Second and six right here. Carrollton showing something in the box. Fountain's going to change the play. Looks to the sidelines. They're going to change it. Still 25 seconds on the clock. They got plenty of time. Carrollton showing man at the top. So they're going to change the play.
Two tight ends in the game for Rome as well. That's the handoff. It's Arthur again. He doesn't get much that time.
John Reed was emphatic to us. We have to be able to run the football. Right now, they've got Carrollton reeling a little bit throwing this ball, but I understand where he's at. Second seven. The, down inside the red zone here almost, and you've got inside the 20.
Yeah, we'll call it the red zone, presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com. Now you're going to see twin receivers on both sides stacked on top of each other. It's the one back, Arthur. Fountain now going to throw. It's caught wide open, 10-yard line, dancing to the 5-yard line. Another big catch for Tynerius Stallings, who was huge in the win against Cass in week one.
Great job there by Fountain getting outside the pocket. He flips his hips, buys some time, and finds his open receiver. And Rome's first and goal right now.
Running back goes in motion, empty backfield. That's going to give Fountain a chance to keep it himself. He's going to go straight ahead. And he's going into the end zone for a touchdown. 6-yard run for Reese Fountain. Puts Rome on the board first.
Nice job right there. They looked like they had Carrollton reeling a little bit, not tackling on the perimeter. Coach Reed said in the pregame opener, look, my quarterback can run too. Good job by Fountain right there. Quarterback draw for a touchdown. Nice drive right there. Second possession for Rome to take the early lead.
You see the strength there of the offensive line and the bodies up front. You also see Rome trying to catch Carrollton napping. And they're going to get an extra yard out of that on the penalty. And presumably that'll keep the Rome offense on the field. They're going to put Jaden Harmon in as a wild. No, yeah, Jaden Harmon in as a wildcat. Remember, he's going to take the snap. He's going to get hit right there in the backfield, though, and he didn't get in.
Remember, we saw them try that against Cass to end the half. Three times they were unable. Right now, I know you got this big time, you know, linebacker right there, but that they're going to have to change that up, I believe, a little bit.
Okay, so let's correct ourselves here. He was apparently
they call
not.
Fountain down. They call Fountain down?
Yeah, they call Fountain down. So it's still 0-0, and they're still running a play from scrimmage here. So that's Harmon again. And Harmon didn't get in again. So let's correct ourselves going back two plays ago.
We had a referee raise his hand.
Yeah, we saw a referee raise his hand, but it was not called a touchdown. Okay. And what we've seen are two plays from scrimmage here with Harmon in a wildcat situation. So now you're looking at fourth down after the two failed tries with Harmon in as a wildcat, something that Rusty said was attempted.
Let's see this.
Yeah, so here is Fountain.
Yeah, he's down.
He is down before. So it's a good call by the officials. And now we're looking at fourth down. Fountain back in. Score 0-0 still.
They might snap this to 20. Yep.
Yeah, how about that? It's Arthur. Now it's going to be a pitch to Hester. And now Hester's going to try to get there, but he won't. And Carrollton has stopped on fourth down. So,
wow.
Reese Fountain, and we'll see it again here. Fountain's going to fake and go out wide. The snap's going to go to Arthur. Arthur's going to pitch to Nick Hester, and then Hester's just going to be met.
Man, they had Carrollton so fooled. If he keeps that, he might score because Carrollton was looking to the sideline.
So wild action here. Fun game brewing. Carrollton and Rome. Stay with us on Peachtree TV.
Hendrick.
Drive now, pay later. Shop HendrickCars.com this month and make no payments for 90 days. Over 20,000 new and pre-owned vehicles. No payments for 90 days. Visit HendrickCars.com.
The Mechanical Trades Institute is an opportunity towards personal financial freedom through hands-on and rewarding work. Our school is completely free and gives apprentices the knowledge and skills required to gain access to a lifelong career path. Apprentices learn pipe fitting, plumbing, mechanical service, and welding. They earn money as they learn and graduate with no student debt. Start a career with the Mechanical Trades Institute and change your financial future.
Struggling with food insecurity can feel lonely, yet every community across America is affected by hunger, which is why our Kroger associates work together to rescue nutritious food that would otherwise go to waste in an effort to donate 3 billion meals by 2025. Because we believe everyone should have access to fresh, delicious food. Join the Kroger Zero Hunger, Zero Waste Foundation to defeat hunger and eliminate food waste.
The Forum River Center in Rome, Georgia is now open and available for meetings and receptions. We're fully equipped for large conventions, sporting events, weddings, and much more. The Forum is located downtown within walking distance of local restaurants, hotels, and boutique shopping. We offer a variety of meeting spaces, many with beautiful river views. Outdoor venues are available for that special touch. With our adjacent parking deck and a personal concierge on site, your event is sure to be a hit. Find out more at forumrivercenter.com.
The GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com drive for the GHSA state title is sponsored by Score Atlanta, your source for Georgia high school sports. HendrickCars.com. Get no payments for 90 days at HendrickCars.com. Experience the Hendrick difference. Sports Turf. You bring the vision, we'll bring it to life. The Georgia Army National Guard. The next generation is now. And by Ford. For great offers on F-150, see your local Ford dealer.
All right, welcome back, everybody. The drive for the GHSA state title presented by FordConstructionCareers.com. Still no score first quarter. Exciting game going between Rome and Carrollton. And after that fourth down stop for Carrollton, Trojans going to get the ball back. Now deep, really right at the end zone after a fourth down stop a moment ago. Juju, flag down. That's going to stop it for Carrollton.
Call startle Carrollton.
A little bit of an issue there with the referee's mic, but you can see the customary signal of the false start. And that's going to put him like right there at the goal line. So not much of a prize for a good defensive stand for the Trojans. Forced to be right back there in the shadow of their own end zone with these Rome fans making a ton of noise right now, sensing the chance to get a momentum play on defense, much like Carrollton possibly had a moment ago.
Rome defensive line here can be very dangerous.
That's going to be the handoff, and there's going to be room to run up the middle. Big game that time for Kamari Farmer.
Big run right there to get Carrollton, who was backed up. Look at Farmer just squeeze through that hole. Jaden Harmon brings him down, gain of 14.
We'll see Rome eventually rotate a little bit at running back. Farmer's gotten the lion's share of the carries for the Trojans in the wake of the Bryce Hicks injury. Here's Juju. First time tonight to see Caleb Odom, the Alabama commit, catch the ball. He's 20-yard line there, got about five.
Yeah, look at Caleb Odom. See the size of him? It's about 6'6". No, he's that new age hybrid, like wide receiver slash tight end. Not going to be attached to the end of the line of scrimmage, but you can line him up in the slot. He's a mismatch on an outside linebacker or safety. But you look at Caleb Odom, his second year transferring over from Villarica. And man, he has exploded the last 2 years in his recruiting.
You see the numbers through two games and really a reflection of the modern sport overall. But what we seem to have a lot of in Georgia here right now, reception going the way of Farmer, and all of a sudden Juju's starting to get into a little bit of a rhythm.
Yep.
They were at the goal line a moment ago, but all of a sudden this drive starting to find some legs.
Yeah, such a quick release on Julian Lewis. You're not going to fool him. He's played, look, this is, he's a sophomore. Hard to believe he started like 17 games now. A lot of kids don't start 17 games in their entire high school career. He's had 17 games. He's played in a state championship. He's played on ESPN. It's going to be hard to fool him, and Coach Reed acknowledged that.
Rome showing pressure, though. The linebacker, Kendall Wright, was sneaking his way up the line of scrimmage. Tight coverage also across on this Rome secondary. Pressure coming Juju's way. Avoids it for now. Now rolling right, throwing right, and it's going to be incomplete. Trying to connect with Ryan Mosley. Already two catches for the day for Mosley, but not able to haul that one in. And there's going to be a flag going against Carrollton, too.
Yeah, we talked about it. They got a holding call right there. We talked about it, Brandon. This front four from Rome. Let's see where the hold is. Right there. See 65 on 48. Yep. See the jersey? Yep. Oh, yeah.
Make it have gotten a couple. He may have gotten a buy one.
I tell you what,
on
if you're going to get a hold of, you get your money's worth, and he got his money's worth. I can assure you there. And again, you start talking about 48. Jarvis Adams, kind of the unsung hero right here.
And keep in mind with that battle up front, you know, you go back and look for the Carrollton loss against Hughes. Carrollton did give up three sacks that day.
Yes.
The Rome defensive line, Joey King believes, probably the strength of this Wolves team. And so watching that battle of Carrollton offensive line, very good Rome defensive line, going to be a big part of the story here today. So it's first and 20 after the penalty. It's Odom there on the left side of the formation. Handoff goes to Farmer again. Farmer looks for a block and he gets it. Going to be driven out of bounds around the 22.
Joe Wilkinson on the tackle there. But I like what I see out of Farmer early on. He's got some juice to him. He's got some bounce to him. Watch him see this hole right here. Put his foot in the ground. He wants to swap that football over because you do not, you want to put it away from those defenders. You want to swap that over to the outside arm, but that's something you'll learn with experience. Keep that in mind later on as we go through the night.
You see the numbers for him on the year. Add to that four catches, one of those coming tonight. And by the way, that's the numbers on tonight, too.
Yeah.
Empty backfield now for Lewis. Lewis, pass complete. Kyan Cofer is there, but he's hitting the backfield. Ryan Sykes, the free safety, is there to meet him. The junior making a big play.
Boy, he read that immediately, Brandon. He saw that release and that step back. Watch how fast number nine shows up right here. Ball's floated a little bit. Didn't help his receiver out coming out of the arm of Julian Lewis, but nice open field tackle. Great recognition by Sykes to see that screen.
Now looking at third down, 1 minute left in our quarter. It's been a breakneck pace, but we've had no scoring as of yet. Third and a long, 17. Here comes that pass rush again, and Lewis is not going to avoid it. Down he goes. There to bring him home on the sack, Rashard Sullivan, senior nose man. How about this Rome defensive front right now?
Right now, they cannot block the front four, and that is great news for Rome because they can do so many things in behind it. They bring Harmon right here, but look at the pass rush, not running pass. And, man, right now, Carrollton is having all kind of issues with this defensive front of Rome.
Sullivan slammed him to the turf impolitely.
I tell you what, I talked to longtime coach Dave Hunter this week, and Dave Hunter told me, he said, Rusty, I know that quarterback's good, but I'm telling you right now, when I saw Roman the Corky Kell, that defense might have been the best I saw all weekend.
Yeah, I thought pound for pound, relative to expectations, I thought that Rome might have been one of the most impressive teams that we saw, and obviously they picked that up here right now. No score, but very impressive there on defense. So we come to an end of the quarter. It's still no score, and it's a great game brewing between Carrollton and Rome here on Peachtree TV.
Thank you for watching Georgia High School Heroes presented by Ingles. I'm Chris Bainbridge, and we're taking a look at some of the greatest high school football players ever to play the game in the great state of Georgia. Having one player from your town on this list is impressive. Having two brothers? Well, that's singularly unique. But that's what we have with the Sharp brothers from Glenville. We've already reviewed the accolades of older brother Sterling. This week, the spotlight shines on Shannon Sharp. The Hall of Fame tight end dazzled in high school, and the field that witnessed his greatness now bears his name. His football prowess took him to Savannah State, where his dominance continued, and eventually to the NFL, where he starred on back-to-back Super Bowl winning teams with the Denver Broncos. His bust now sits in Canton, Ohio. Thanks for watching Georgia High School Heroes, presented by Ingles.
Excitement comes standard with the Honda Accord, and so does a turbocharged engine. Sophisticated, high-tech, style that enhances functionality. Stand out with the Honda Accord. From Honda, the most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Contact your Honda dealer today or shop online.
And we are back. Second quarter action about to get underway. Rome going to get the football. And Carrollton, no score here. Nothing. Brandon Adams, Rusty Manziel. Happy to have you with us as our drive for the GHSA state title. Presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com. Gets rolling after a couple of great weeks of our Great Atlanta Bash and our Corky Kell Dave Hunter Classic. We knew this would be a great way to start things off, and thus far it has been exciting to say the least. Another punt coming. Another high one.
Wow, good punt.
Fair catch going to be called. 46-yard line. So that's going to bring the Wolves back on offense. And by the way, speaking of Rome, you know, Georgia's Rome invites you to experience the natural beauty of Rome's rivers as you cruise the river in style on the Sulzbacher Roman Holiday. Plan your fun and purchase tickets online at romegeorgia.org/Roman Holiday. So that looks like a lot of fun. Just down the road from where we are here at Barron Stadium tonight. And the homestanding Wolves trying to find the game's first points. With Reese Fountain back in at quarterback. Gonna be four receivers, three down linemen for Carrollton defensively. Snap to Fountain. He's gonna hurry. He's gonna get it off to Arthur. Complete, but down way behind the line of scrimmage. So good job defensively to keep Arthur where he was. CJ Gamble, the sophomore linebacker, on the tackle.
Yeah, they wanted to throw this screen right here. And he went back to his progressions, just hit his check down. And Arthur did as much as he could. Still lost 5 yards on that, but good job, Carrollton, defending that screen at the top. See the splits on the Rome right here?
Carrollton showing pressure. Fountain, incomplete. Was going to try to hit Hester. Perhaps miscommunication on that.
Yeah, I think Hester ran in. I think he thought he was going to break out. Quick two downs. You're now your 3rd and 13. We'll be careful right here.
Kelvin Hill, the senior cornerback, had the coverage.
Man, points could be a premium, and you go back and make a mark of that. Brandon Brome had the ball 1st and goal on the 1-yard line, didn't get it in.
You see what Fountain has done on the night.
Watch three here at the bottom. This is a 3-by-1 set. This is what they hurt Cass with, this one at the bottom if they go to it.
Fountain looks that way. Pressure coming his way now. Going to have to hurry, and he won't get rid of it. There to bring him home on the sack. Landon Wolf, a linebacker, hurt a week ago, and yet able to be a part of a team of Trojans who bring Reese Fountain down.
Yeah, he's looking at DK Daniel, but unable to get out of pass rush, unable to get his feet set. Carrollton defensive line eventually gets to Fountain right there for the sack, and a quick 3 and out.
Uh-oh. Low snap, and the punt is going to be blocked. And Carrollton comes up with a huge play on special teams and phenomenal field position. A.J. McNeil is the guy who falls to the football. Didn't see who got the block, but it's McNeil who came up with it. And the Trojans are going to have it in great field position.
Oh, man, bad snap right here. And Carrollton was coming again, as you see. At that point.
Yeah, so it's McNeil who blocked it, and he fell on it. Jaden Thompson was also almost in there.
I'll tell you what, right here, you watch Odom at the top of the screen. Rome's bringing safety help over. Let's see if Juju Lewis takes a shot here with a little momentum after that turnover.
Instead, they're going to do the running play, and it's going to be room to run. And inside the 5. And down, another carry for Kamari Farmer that comes up big.
Nice job by the Carrollton offensive line there. Just spread him out, give him a little bit of space, and Farmer does the rest. Good job blocking that time by the Carrollton offensive line.
His burst and quickness is fantastic.
I'm telling you, Joy King sounded confident in him.
He did.
You
know. All right, we are in the red zone here, presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com. Juju will be in the shotgun. It's 1st and goal now. A little bit of a bunch formation for the Trojans. Tight end goes in motion. Juju handoff again. Met in the backfield again. Rome is just so tough up front right now.
Yeah, I think they're going to get some out in space probably. I'm not sure they're going to be able to just block those four guys. They've had a couple of long bursts, but you know that Rome right here is going to tighten it down. You see them win the line of scrimmage right there. Linebacker closes down. Number 23, Trey Scales, also closes the gap.
Different looking formation here.
Jumbo's a heavy set.
It's going to be a pitch to Farmer. Farmer once again met in the backfield, and you can try anything you want. Rome is just there to meet it.
Yeah, they try to go quick pitch at a heavy set. And you see big 98 right there. the NC State commit, having nothing of that in Justin Terrell. Look at him just dominating his blocker, pushes him all the way back, and then Scales, 23, again steps in there unblocked and makes the play.
All right, here we go. Big third down. You lose a couple yards now, put the ball at the 3-yard line. More traditional looking formation. It is Odom, the Alabama commit, on the right side of this formation. That's number 7, bottom right-hand corner of your screen. Keep your eye over there if Juju wants to go that way, and he will, and Odom's going to go up, and he's going to get it for a touchdown. Rome fans were asking for him to be ruled out of bounds. Referees, officials looked at each other, but they finally agreed. Odom gets the touchdown from 3 yards out. Juju strikes first here on the road.
See right here. Sooner or later, you got to go to him. I mean, he's 6'5". Yep.
Hey, got it in.
Yep.
Got it in.
Nice call there by the referees. And look, that's just, you can't guard that. It's hard to guard a 6'5" wide receiver in high school.
And they're going to do the fake, the 2-point conversion, and then the referee's going to blow the whistle. So we see this from time to time, kind of the muddle huddle type play of trying to catch the defense in a bad formation. But they may have gone a little too quick that time.
Yeah, Carrollton's really tried to hurt Rome and special teams. They did on the bad snap. They tried to block a punt. They tried to catch him off guard right there on a 2-point play out of extra point.
It's Carlos Hernandez who's going to try the PAT, one of two Carrollton kickers that we'll see tonight. And it's low, and it's just a little bit short, so it's not good. So Carrollton finds the game's first touchdown, but not able to connect on the PAT, so that keeps our score at 6-0. We got quite a pace going here between the Trojans and the Wolves, and we are glad to have you with us on Peachtree TV.
Hey, does it matter if this leaks?
It don't matter to me, can't see it from my house.
Illegal use of hands and proper training.
GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com has 14 different highly skilled trades with tuition-free training in our certified apprenticeship programs to train you the right way. Find your career at GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com.
The Georgia Sheet Metal JETC equips apprentices with the knowledge and skills required to start a rewarding career in the sheet metal industry with programs in HVAC, industrial welding, and testing, adjusting, and balancing. Training is 100% free and allows apprentices to earn as they learn. Journeymen graduate with no student debt and have the potential to earn more than most college graduates. Visit our website to learn more about this opportunity at careersinsheetmetal.com.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
In the blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
And we are back. Carrollton strikes first, 6-0. The Caleb Odom touchdown a moment ago, giving the Trojans the lead. In fact, we'll check it out here as a part of our Breda Pest Management scoring summary. 4 plays, 21 yards, 2 minutes, 3 seconds off the clock. All started because of a blocked punt for the Trojans and finished off by Odom, who gets the 3-yard reception. Brandon Adams, Rusty Manziel. I think both these teams right now are finding some things that they like, and obviously fans here, I believe, are getting an incredibly entertaining football game. And I still get the impression we may slightly be in the feeling out process still.
Yeah, I mean, you're still well within the game right now. A couple of possessions for each team. I think Rome has definitely found some things they like on the perimeter from their quarterback, Reese Fountain. And I think sooner or later, Carrollton had to go to their guy, and they went to him right there, Caleb Odom, for a touchdown. Just so hard to guard at 6'5".
Julian Vargas kicks it to Nick Hester, and Hester out of bounds there, shy of the 20-yard line. And while we have a moment, let me remind you about our friends at Breda Pest Management, because nobody wants unwanted guests taking up residence in their homes. And I'm not talking in this particular instance about your in-laws. What I'm talking about are critters. And when it comes to keeping critters out of your house, there's just one company to call them. That's my friends at Breda Pest Management. We certainly appreciate Breda Pest Management for their dedication to Georgia high school athletics. I would say thus far, and perhaps the stats back this up, it seems like Rome has found a little bit more balance than I think that Carrollton's been able to find.
I think Rome's really hurt them on a couple of big plays here, and it's been what Joey King was worried about. He said, look, we're worried about these receivers on the perimeter and tackling one-on-one.
So Rome has found the balance, but they have not found yet our points. Another carry for Arthur, and Arthur's... That doesn't look good right now. Terrific running back, the junior, 106 yards in the win against Cass, a game that we started our season that Friday night on Peachtree TV, and boy, you hate to see that, Rusty. My indication is
holding
he looks
ankle.
To be hurt right now, so yep. We're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll come back, try to give you an update on Chance Arthur, the Rome running back, after this.
The Peachtree TV Friday night game of the week. Milton versus Roswell, next Friday at 8. High school football on Peachtree TV, Atlanta's own CW. Sponsored locally by these sponsors.
Every morning you expect the unexpected, like all four seasons in a day. You need a morning team.
It gets you ready for everything.
Ready for Mother Nature with the first alert from Atlanta's biggest weather team. Atlanta News First. Every morning, ready for everything.
Attention, it's time for the morning announcements. Make sure your parents are aware of the Ingalls Tools for Schools program and ask them to link their Ingalls Advantage card to our school. Remember, you have to do it each year. Now please stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I may be known for my legendary football career, but truth is, I love a bunch of sports. The only trouble is knowing where to find them. That's why I got Xfinity, so I can easily find and watch whatever sport I'm into all in one place without missing a thing. Even if it's football, Australian football, or football. In a word, it's Fitzcredible. Gotta trademark that one.
And this season, Xfinity Internet and TV customers can get up to $200 off NFL Sunday Ticket from YouTube.
The GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com drive for the GHSA state title is sponsored by Kroger. Boost by Kroger Plus. More savings, more benefits, a new level of membership. Dog Nation. Visit DogNation.com for the latest Georgia team news and recruiting information. Georgia's Rome, where the rivers meet and the mountains begin. The Governor's Office of Highway Safety. Seatbelts save lives. The Governor's Office of Highway Safety reminds you to buckle up before every trip. And by the U.S. Army, be all you can be.
Okay, welcome back, everybody. You see the injury report presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, and you do see Chance Arthur, the running back from Rome, a terrific player. He is walking off on his own power, but obviously appearing to be in some pain there, Rusty, so... We'll keep our eye on what that turns into. We're conditioned last couple of weeks, hot weather. You know, guys get the cramps, but that's fairly obviously not that. I won't speculate on severity, you know, beyond that, but that's obviously not a cramping situation.
Yeah, he got tackled low, and it's just part of the game. Good, clean hit, but obviously felt that one afterwards. We'll see if he comes back in the game. Fountain throws the ball there. That wasn't his best pass of the night, and a little bit short. I think he kind of rushed that one. This is a big third and five right here, and we'll get the ball right back to Carrollton.
Running back McDermott goes in motion. The pass is complete to Hester, but it's going to be short of a first down. That's going to bring up fourth ball to the 31-yard line. I should say 26-yard line.
Yeah, Fountain just rushed those last two balls there. You want to step into that, hit your guy in space so he can run up the field. And that left Rome in a fourth and one, and they have to punt this one.
Yeah, that's going to bring on for the Wolves a punting situation. Corey Gardhigh going to be called upon to do that. Gardhigh gets a pretty good punt away. Fair catch called for, 37-yard line. So Gardhigh gets a pretty good one and kind of helps Rome flip the field. And that's going to bring Carrollton back on offense. They got the game's first touchdown a moment ago, and now they get the football again. And while we have a moment, let's see the resume for Carrollton. Of course, Joey King, speaking of resumes, as impressive.
94-8.
A resume as you can have, going back to state championship years at Cartersville, of course, with the legendary quarterback Trevor Lawrence there. Made the state final a year ago in their first year in the 7A classification. You see notable alumni such as Reggie Brown, Chas Chambliss, who's at Georgia right now, Jonathan Jones at Auburn. Of course, all of this brought to you by Smart Local 85. And it's kind of interesting. You know, so much was made a year ago of Buford, their first year in the highest classification. Carrollton probably a little bit overlooked, but ultimately they end up having the better season.
They got better, and they got on a roll as the season went on, and they got better with a young quarterback.
Lewis, the handoff, room to run, and more. Up to the 45-yard line goes Kamari Farmer. Pickup of 17 yards.
Great job there blocking, just sealed off the edge. Rome defender, watch a Rome defender come up. He runs past him right there, missed the tackle. 35 linebacker there, right, just comes a little too far off his angle, and Farmer made him pay with a big gain.
Lewis now surveying the scene. Time to throw, ball tipped though. Trying to connect with Odom again. Odom, the Alabama commit, had a touchdown the previous drive, but that ball was deflected.
Yeah, we got a tip ball there. You know, Rome's doing a good job of not rushing up the field. They're keeping Juju in the pocket, not allowing him to get outside, because he can use his legs. He likes to throw the ball, obviously, from a clean pocket, but he can hurt you outside of it. But right now, Rome being very disciplined up the field in their pass rush.
Three receivers, two of those on the right side, one of which McNeil goes in motion. Hand off to Farmer. Farmer's got a beautiful cut, and he stays on his feet. How about that? 30, 25, out of bounds around the 23. Pickup of about 23, and that is quite a luxury to have that as a guy who started the season as a backup running back.
Yeah, that's people that are playing Carrollton are watching this going, wait a minute, this guy's a sophomore? Wait a minute now, we didn't sign up for this.
Chains moving, and all of a sudden this Carrollton offense finding a spark it did not have in the first quarter.
Yep.
Tight end going to detach. Left side of the formation, becoming like a third receiver. McNeil in motion again. Now they're going to throw that way.
RPO.
Yeah. And he's going to be out of bounds around the 20. Catch for A.J. McNeil.
That is a Gus Malzahn special.
It is. A little pop pass like Malzahn did long time.
Nick Marshall ran that to D.C.'s nightmares.
Of course, plenty of non-Auburn SEC fans will tell you they did so with the offensive lineman 15 yards down the field in some cases, too. That's what some SEC fans might say. 6:35 to go in our first half. Now facing third down. And we're in the red zone presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com. Three receivers going to be on your right side. Odom is going to be the lone man on the left. Juju Lewis, the USC committed quarterback, going to hand the ball off, then become a blocker. And that's going to allow Farmer to stay on his feet, and he's going to go into the end zone for a touchdown. But let's hold everything for a flag. So let's see what this is, but Lewis, after handing the ball off, became a blocker. Lincoln Riley's like, I'm not sure I want you to do that.
I think Joey King can back him off as that as well, but that shows how competitive he is.
Let's get the indication on the call.
The spot of the foul call.
Okay, yeah, so it is a hold, but as Rusty said, it's a spot foul, which is going to still back him up and make it third down, but because of where the holding takes place, not as bad as it possibly could have been. You see Lewis kind of getting involved there. Now he's going to try to throw. He's got to hurry. Pressure coming. Adams is chasing him down. Flag comes in again, and Lewis takes a huge loss all the way back to the 45. He lost 19 of his play stance, but there is a flag.
Yeah, just a young quarterback there. You got to find a way to get rid of that. I know he had immediate pressure, but when he turned around, you got to get rid of that ball. Just a young quarterback trying to make a lot out of nothing, and he cost his team some big yards right there.
So it's a hold on Carrollton. Rome's going to decline that and bring up fourth down.
Oh, my goodness. They tackled 95, and they've got a hold of 48. I'm telling you right now, as this game goes on, Carrollton is having a lot more success running the ball because they can't pass block this front four so far.
And it's interesting, you know, you mentioned this, that number 98, Justin Terrell, that's an NC State commit. That's your Power 5 guy.
Yeah.
But Sullivan, the senior nose man.
Yes.
You know, you think about Adams, the kind of an FCS-level recruit,
sure,
the defensive end, that's number 48. These guys are playing as well as Terrell is, who's more of a Power 5 type commit. Low wobbly punt. Rolling inside the 10. Are they going to get down there and get it? Yes, they did.
Big
play on special teams is going to put Rome as backed up against the end zone as is possible without actually being inside of pay dirt. Let's see this again, the hustle here. Incredible job that time by Zion Cooley, who gets down there and helps drop that ball right there at the goal line. Our Rome resume now presented by Smart Local 85. John Reed in his ninth season. State championships galore in the state semifinals a year ago. Of course, back-to-back, though, in 2016, 2017. I think about Jemias Griffin, the terrific player that went on.
He's now at Ole Miss.
That's exactly right. Yeah,
yep.
Kind of a late pickup for the Rebels.
Yep.
Boy, the transfer portal never quite closes in Oxford, does it?
Hey, I mean, I think Lane was in, like, week two of camp and said, hey, let's dip back in this thing. Jemias Griffin, who was Gatorade Player of the Year in the state of Georgia.
You know who else added a late transfer, too, is South Carolina, the defensive end from UAB,
correct,
who was trying to graduate.
Tell me what they're going to be in here. We good?
Nice, as we say in the industry, natural sound coming from John Reed on the sidelines. But that's been fun this year. We've had a lot of that.
Yep.
Fountain from his end zone, throwing.
Oof.
Dangerous throw for a moment.
Man.
It's complete to D.K. Daniel, but for a moment I thought that Kelvin Hill, the senior cornerback, might be there for that.
Man, that was almost dangerous.
All right, second down now. That's the handoff to McDermott. McDermott would have played plenty anyway, but he may be getting the lion's share of the duty the rest of the game because of the Chance Arthur injury that we showed you a little earlier, Arthur leaving the field with what looked to be a leg injury. Move the chains, make it first down. McDermott again. And, you know, to give you an idea, you know, John Reed kind of compared McDermott a little bit to Bryce Hicks, the injured running back from Carrollton, in terms of a back they can carry the ball with, but also they don't have any problem throwing the ball out of the backfield too.
This is where Rome likes to go here, the bottom.
Fountain.
Pump
gonna
and
now
go.
Throw towards the sideline. Hester is there, but it's gonna be, is he inbounds? It's intercepted. There to pick that off is Kelvin Hill. Now they're gonna say incomplete. So the initial indication was an interception. Another official ran over. Sidebar results in an incomplete.
Yeah, let's see here. They tried to get him on a pump and go. Great job. Look at him in phase right there. Yep. See, out of bounds? Yep. Left foot's out of bounds. But great job by the defensive back there to stay in phase, make a play. He's watching the ball. Great job by Hill. Corner, senior corner there for Carrollton.
Fountain throwing again. Sideline again. Over the head, though, of D.K. Daniel. That's going to bring up fourth down. And that'll send guard high on again to punt for Rome. So Wolves have found some success on offense, but it's not been a full, complete drive as of yet, and John Reed is as animated as ever.
Yeah, Round looks a little rushed right here. Like, get your feet set. You know, I think he's got more time than you think he does. He's been really hot, but a couple of the last throws, he's got to get his feet settled. Step into those throws.
Low snap again. Guard high, lucky to get away. The previous punt was blocked. This one may have been touched, and it's going to roll dead at the Rome 25. So
special teams is killing Rome right now.
I believe that one was touched, and Carrollton, who used a block punt for a touchdown, is going to have pretty close to the same thing again right now.
Carrollton's on first and 10 at the Rome 25.
I mean, Rome defensively has played great. The two times they've been put in this position right here was because of special teams.
It would be a backbreaker to have played as well as they have defensively in the first half and still be staring at a two-score deficit. That's obviously what the Wolves are going to try to prevent right now. Three receivers right side, tight end detached. Juju going to throw left side, though, and it's a fight for the football. A flag comes in. Odom obviously makes the catch, but let's see what the ruling's going to be. Or at least I should say he came up with the football, whether he's in bounds or not. Yeah, he's way out of bounds.
He caught that off his back.
It's an amazing catch. It doesn't count because both of his feet were out of bounds, but you can't make a better catch than that.
The difference there was the Rome defender was not looking back at the ball. He was face into Odom, where the Carrollton defensive back was in phase and he was looking back for the ball.
Defensive pass interference. Penalty will be half the distance to the goal. First down.
So just for the sake of conversation, is that a catchable ball?
If Juju had that to throw over, he'd want to throw that on the back shoulder because of the size difference.
But relative to the penalty.
Yeah, yeah, catchable ball, yep. He catches it off the guy's back.
The fact that he caught it, obviously.
He caught it off his back. That's called ball skills there. It's like me at a barbecue joint. I got barbecue skills. Those were ball skills.
I hear that. Hand off again to Farmer.
Nice job.
Terrell is there to stop him. Four minutes to go in the half now. We are in the red zone presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com.
And you're second and nine right here. I've got to be looking at number seven. Just too much of a mismatch. This part of the field, you're going to see him at the top. He's going to be one-on-one.
Yeah, left side of the formation, as Rusty said. Farmer hit again in the backfield. Did he get free? Did the ball come out? Yeah. It looks like an offensive lineman. That's a Zakai Hilton, Helton, I should say, the Alabama commit, the center, just a sophomore, who I believe came up with that football. Let's see how this happens. Handoff goes to Farmer.
98 puts his helmet on. 48 puts his helmet. Look at the ball on the ground. 48 put his helmet on the ball. The ball is laying there.
Up for grabs for anybody, and it's Zakai Hilton, a sophomore Alabama commit at the center position.
That is a center's dream.
It really is. Maybe the first time.
It's one carry of the year.
Joey King said some nice things about him. Already a good lineman, saying over the course of the next couple of years, also going to grow into a leader for this program. Heads up play on that. And we got a timeout. Rome calls it. They want to make sure they know what's happening here on this third down play. It's third and five, so we're not in a goal-to-go situation. Let's also celebrate here our Georgia High School Football Hall of Fame induction ceremony to take place later on in the month of October. And one of the guys going in, the former Atlanta Falcon, the former Georgia Bulldog, TV star here in the Atlanta area now, DJ Shockley, doing some great things for his father there with North Clayton. And on his way on October 21st, into enshrinement in the Georgia High School Football Hall of Fame, and what a cool thing that is.
What a man, Shock. Look how good he looked in that jersey, number three. And that was those big jerseys. He looked even better now with some tightness on there.
That's exactly right.
That man's got a welding curtain on right there, number three.
And that number three for Georgia looks a lot better than that number three for Florida last night, both on the field at the same time.
Goodness.
Taking a touchdown off the board for the Gators.
What do you think? What do you think Kirby Smart, how he would have dealt with that?
Oh, my gosh. I believe Kirby Smart would have been fit to be tied if that would have happened to his team.
Big play, third and five.
Yeah.
Carrollton goes three, stacked to the top.
Empty backfield now, too. Throw in left side, looking for some blockers. And it's going to be Farmer. And he's going to get in and score. Touchdown for Kamari Farmer through the air.
How many times we see that, Brandon? A team comes out of a timeout. That was Rome's timeout, but it gave Carrollton a chance. And they just throw this little quick perimeter screen here to their running back, and nobody touches him until he gets into the end zone. Carrollton again capitalizes on a special teams play for another touchdown.
That's going to send Carlos Hernandez back out from the PAT. Did miss his first. Interesting story involving these Carrollton kickers. They had a kicker a year ago, earn a scholarship to Jacksonville State. Joey King said next day, we had six soccer players standing outside my door. They all wanted to play.
In line.
They were ready. And this time, Hernandez is true. And that makes the lead now 13-0 for Carrollton over Rome. Wolves defense has played great, but Carrollton still has the lead. Hey, Atlanta Falcons getting ready to get back in action next week. And, of course, group ticket packages are also available for Falcons home games. You can learn more about all kinds of options for youth sports teams, client hosting events, and so much more. Check out atlantafalcons.com/tickets for more on that.
Falcons football. It's Grady putting quarterbacks on notice. It's Kyle shredding defenses like a unicorn. It's Tyler breaking tackles like phone screens. It's AJ locking down anyone on his island. It's Drake touching the sun. It's CP breaking another record. What is Falcons football? It's all you dirty birds. Rise up.
Looking, and there you go. How about a nice old school Deion Sanders jersey out here? You talk about seamless transition, but also great to see a little respect for Atlanta Falcons legend there, Deion Sanders, who, by the way, is the head coach for Colorado, will have his debut tomorrow against TCU. We'll see our scoring summary here brought to you by Breda Pass Manager there, too. We're Rusty, a little bit of an issue with his microphone. Scoring summary brought to you by Breda Pass Manager, 26 yards, 137 off the clock, three plays. Kamari Farmer, the running back, gets the touchdown through the air. And Juju Lewis thrown two touchdowns here today. The USC commit, ESPN ranks him as the number one recruit in the country regardless of classification. So no shortage of hype for him right now and living up to that with a couple of nice drives here today. Returnable for Rome. That's Hester trying to go right side. Now going to try to go up the middle, and it's going to be, ooh, boy, a tough situation there. Does not really get even hardly past the 10-yard line, so long field for Rome with 2:33 left in the half. So we'll get Rusty's mic working here again. And
am I back?
Now you are. Okay. Now we can hear you.
All right, here we go. What I was saying is Hester obviously got a lot of speed. This is a young man that set out last year for Rome, and they are excited about having him back this year.
Yeah, 9 catches the win against Cass. And that's a 34-0 win against a team that, you know, won the playoffs last year, a really marquee-type win against Jefferson. What Rome did on that first Friday night, you and I briefly touched on this a little bit earlier, that was as impressive as anything, I think, pound for pound, we saw during the Corky Kale Dave Hunter Classic.
Yeah. Yeah, oh, yeah. I mean, that game was a lot closer than the ending score, but, man, Rome, I've seen Rome now 3 times this year, and defensively they're very, very strong.
So Fountain to throw, going to look left side. Daniel is there, ball caught, 20-yard line. That's a guy you know they want to get involved. Got the gold gloves on, that's nice. Hand off, McDermott, going to lower his shoulder and move the chains for Rome. Clock a little bit of a factor here. 2:11, stopping to move the chains. Three-man front for Carrollton. Fountain looking left side again. Daniel again. He's going to go up and get it there. 45-yard line.
Wow.
Nice strike. 17 yards on the completion.
Great pass there by Fountain. Layering it over that corner, but DK Daniel goes up and high points. He's got to throw this over this defensive back in the front and drop it in the bucket, and Daniel goes and gets it.
Here comes Rome. Fountain wants to play fast. Running play. Maybe got two. You see McDermott there, 16 carries, 66 yards, in the win against Cass that we were mentioning a moment ago. McDermott now in motion. Fountain going to run. He's going to get across the 50. Tackle made that time by Zion Cooley.
That's an added package they've added this year. Fountain has gained weight. He's around 190 pounds, and you know, that makes you game plan for his legs.
Here's the handout to McDermott. McDermott hit in the backfield. Carrollton's turn to be active up front. Stopping his
man
progress was Montrez Smith, the Duke commit.
Big decision right here for John Reed, because the ball is at midfield. He's going to call timeout and think about this, because if you don't get this, Carrollton steals a possession.
Yeah, and if anybody's capable of doing the I won't call it a two-minute drive because we're inside of a minute, but that just seems like the kind of thing that Juju Lewis might be made for on the road.
Correct.
While we have a moment, let's see the Rome schedule presented by Personal Touch Lawn Care. Of course, we're still in that kind of fun pre-region time of the year. How about next week, against Pebblebrook, Dwight Phillips, the outstanding Georgia running back commit. That's going to be a fun game.
A game they were down last year in the fourth quarter, came back to win that one. So John Reed knows he's got his hands full tonight and next week.
And also, I think, given the way that Rome has played thus far, you know, last week's game against Lithonia, they were up huge in the first half and probably coasted a little bit in the second. Of course, the win we talked about earlier against Cass. I think Rome sent a pretty big message here. They're going to be a huge factor in the 6A classification. Not that they're ever not, but when you think about the, obviously, the Langston Hugheses and the Gainesvilles, and, you know, you're going to have to put Rome in that category too.
And, I mean, obviously, Rome got to the Final Four last year. And, listen, they got beat really bad by Langston Hughes, but most everybody got beat really bad by Langston Hughes.
Common denominator for these two teams in the field tonight, it was Carrollton losing in a thrilling game to Langston Hughes in week one. That was the battle of the great quarterbacks, Aaron Nolan on his way to Ohio State from Hughes, and obviously Lewis in our game tonight on his way to USC. And that was the team, as Rusty said, that also eliminated Rome in the state semifinals last year. Hughes may very well win it again. I don't know the gap between Langston Hughes and the rest of the competition this year is as wide as it was a year ago. Is that fair, or do you disagree?
I'll tell you what, Aaron Nolan. No, I don't think it. I don't think they're quite as good, but, man, they are, as they get to game 15, if they get that far, they may be.
Okay, fourth down here. As Rusty said, it's a big play, and it's going to be a completion. Hester gets it, stays on his feet near the 30-yard line, 31, 32-yard line. And a heady play there by the senior quarterback to move the chains. They had to have it.
Love the call here. Just a quick pop pass to your slot receiver. And Nick Hester does the rest. Great call coming out of a timeout.
As we said earlier, Fountain 29-5 as a starter. It's plays like that that have made that so.
They're coming.
Quick throw by Fountain again. It's Hester again. Hester going to be driven out of bounds. Jaden Thompson, the senior safety, there to do so. 45 seconds left in the half.
Well, Carrollton had a busted coverage. Fountain got rid of the ball so quick he didn't see it, but nobody guarded the outside wide receiver. He was running free for a touchdown, and Fountain motions to the sideline. Hey, did y'all see that? So put that back in your memory for later in the game, maybe.
On second down, Fountain going to be looking left side again. Got time. Not going to throw towards the end zone. Hester just over his head. Thompson had the coverage again. So we've seen one completion tonight to Tynaria Stallings, and everything else has gone the way of either Daniel or
Everything's
Hester.
Been to the left.
It's all been to the left.
Everything's been to the left.
Is that a coincidence, or is that something they see?
That's just comfort level. 3 and 4 are his guys. You know what I mean? And you got to mix it up, but right now it's 3 or 4.
Already 5 catches tonight for Hester. Now Fountain will throw right side. That's the running back, McDermott. And he's going to get inside the 15-yard line.
That's a great job right there. Fountain climbed the pocket and had enough arm strength to whip that ball. Watch the arm angle right here when he throws that ball out there. And a great job by McDermott. You see what Coach Reed was talking about, comparing him to Bryce Hicks. That's where Bryce Hicks would hurt you.
Red Zone presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com. Ball rests at about the 14-yard line. Fountain will look right side again. That's going to be complete.
Got to get out of bounds, man.
Inside the 10. Did he get out of bounds? Yeah, I think you're going to say yes. Stallings gets his second catch of the night. So,
ooh, that would drive. That was that one last juke back to the middle of the field. Right there, you want to get out of bounds.
Yeah,
see him step back in.
Mm,
you do not want to lose precious seconds right now. Rome's got to punch it in. We've seen them before against Cass have issues right here in this end zone at this particular time of the game. They've got to punch it in right here for a touchdown.
Three receivers left side. Carrollton showing pressure. Coming after Fountain, he goes down. C.J. Kelly, the junior defensive lineman.
Wow, cannot take one right there. Rome has to call a timeout. See where he comes from. just right up the middle.
Boy, great play by Kelly, getting some college interest, a guy that Joey King says got a bright future. And my gosh, he picked a great time to display some of that potential there. And while we have the timeout, Rome stopping the clock to think about what it wants to do. We'll also see the Carrollton schedule. We told you about the thrilling win against, or I should say, a loss against Langston Hughes, bouncing back last week against South Paulding. And then you start thinking about 7A region action. You know, you start looking October 20th, the game late in the season against Westlake. Before that, Pebble Brook, obviously East Coweta, always tough. You start thinking about Carrollton being a major factor in that Region 6, or I should say Region 2, 7A classification.
That game on 10-20, that's a grown man game.
That's a big-time game right there.
I'm telling you, everybody warned me about Westlake, and I probably didn't listen enough. Well, guess what? I need to start listening because Westlake is for real.
Especially up front offensive line.
No doubt. Huge. Juan Gaston, big 6'7", 330-pounder.
Also, while we have a chance, can we send a shout-out to Creekside here as they take on modern day in California
week? Knowing them, they're probably sitting around watching right now.
Hey, listen, if they are, just know everybody in Georgia is rooting for you guys and proud of you. Got a win last week against St. Peter's.
Yeah, man.
We should also
modern day.
Third and 14 here. Big moment in our first half. Fountain to the end zone. Hester
broke up.
Is incomplete. He dropped it.
Let's see if Keyshawn Johnson, number 9, gets in there right at the end. Let's see what angle we got here. Yeah, Johnson got his hand on it.
Yeah, good
great
play.
Coverage. My goodness, you can't play. Ball was perfect, but perfect defense right there by defensive back.
So on fourth down, they can get a first. There's only 8 seconds left, but Rome going to roll the dice here. They want points.
Got to throw it.
Fountain's going to have to hurry. Nowhere to go. Ball comes free. Now it's going to be picked up and way, way short. Carrollton gets a huge stop, and that's how our first half is going to end. The Trojans stand up big, and they keep the Wolves off the board. What a thrilling conclusion to what has been a fun first half. Rome has all kinds of opportunities, and as of yet, not able to cash any of them in. Halftime show coming up. Thrilling second half after that.
Hendrick.
Drive now, pay later. Shop HendrickCars.com this month and make no payments for 90 days. Over 20,000 new and pre-owned vehicles. No payments for 90 days. Visit HendrickCars.com.
Beginning the morning you opened your eyes, we spent every waking moment preparing you for the day you'd leave our nest. Whether it's driving to practice or helping with homework, it's all prepared you for, what am I going to be when I grow up? Will you be ready?
After much thought, I've made my decision to take my talents to the IBEW Local 613.
The International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers is not simply a job. It's a career. Visit IBEW613.org to begin a new future today.
My marriage kind of took a different path. He told me he was not moving back into the home. My biggest fear was the unknown. What would happen with the children and myself? What would happen with the house? I found Meriwether and Tharp. They told me that they would walk me through this divorce, and they did that tenfold. You need an attorney. You need the best attorney, and that's going to be Meriwether and Tharp.
I've used R.S. Andrews 15 years, purchased 2 heating and air systems, so I rely on their technicians for service. I call, they come, it's fixed. And I appreciate Andrew's commitment. He gives it his all. That's how R.S. Andrews makes me smile.
Yikey Wawa! Running out of hot water is one way your water heater cries out for help. Call R.S. Andrews. Get a water heater rejuvenation. Your water heater gets added life, you get more hot water. Another way R.S. Andrews makes you smile today.
And welcome to the Halftime Show, brought to you by SportsTurf. I'm Kaylee Mansell, and I am joined by Rome Athletic Director Chris Bowden. There are so many things that I can talk to you about, but tonight we're going to focus on a very special group of people, the trainers for Rome High School. They're a part of Atrium Health Rome, and they just received
Ladies
a prestigious award from the National Athletic Trainers Association. What was the criteria for the award, and how awesome is it to know that your school was the recipient of that?
Well, what's incredible here in Rome, as you know, growing up in this area, the medical field is incredible. I mean, the hospital's right here next to the stadium. I mean, that's what we use their parking lots for this game. And it starts with them and their involvement, their support. They supply our athletic trainers, which we have two full-time trainers that take care of all of our student athletes. And then we built our new College and Career Academy with an incredible athletic training facility. And so you put all of those things together, it just impacts getting our kids and keeping our kids healthy. So the criteria was basically there's a whole list of things that they require you in order to receive this award. Because of their support, because of Dr. Holland, our superintendent, Park Wilkinson, our principal, we're able to receive this. And that's a big deal.
I think that we can all agree, X's and O's, wins and losses aside, the priority out there is the safety of these kids. So how awesome is it knowing that your student athletes are in such good hands?
Well, it's vital. Mm-hmm. I mean, we do everything to make sure that we have great coaches, we have great teachers. We try to be on the forefront of the cutting edge of everything. And then that goes with this as well. Mm-hmm. Our trainers arrive in the middle of fourth block, which is the end of the day. And if a student athlete needs some treatment, we're able to get them treated as soon as possible to get them at practice or get them after school to get them ready to be able to play on, say, a Friday night.
And I think one thing that really is underappreciated and goes not as recognized is not only are trainers now required to help with the physical aspects of students, but also the mental aspect of it as well. So talk about the importance of these trainers being able to recognize when there's a need to address mental health situations too.
Well, trainers, it's such a unique thing because they catch young people in a more relaxed setting. Mm-hmm. And sometimes student athletes will feel more free to open up. And so that works hand in hand with our coaches, with our staff, and with our counselors at our school. So it really is a good working relationship, and we're able to be prepared to help our student athletes maximize their performance on the field and then be successful so they can graduate and become what they want to become.
Well, Mr. Bowden, it has been so awesome to have you on. It's always so awesome to see your smiling face running around
everywhere.
This track all the time. Thank you for all that you do, and I'm really glad we got to recognize the trainers out here today. Now let's take a look at the Carrollton Band presented to you by Meriwether and Tharp.
At Ingles, we're proud to partner with area athletics. From Little League to the pros, college tournaments to high school heroes, it's all in the bag.
He could go all the way!
Yeah! Ingles, low prices, love the savings.
You don't have to wake up on the right side of the bed to know how you like your coffee, as long as it's McCafe coffee from Mickey D's. Now that's what you like.
Mix and match two breakfast hits for $4.49. Add any size iced coffee for $1.79.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I may be known for my legendary football career, but truth is, I love a bunch of sports. The only trouble is knowing where to find them. That's why I got Xfinity, so I can easily find and watch whatever sport I'm into all in one place without missing a thing. Even if it's football, Australian football, or football. In a word, it's Fitzcredible. Gotta trademark that one.
And this season, Xfinity Internet and TV customers can get up to $200 off NFL Sunday Ticket from YouTube.
America, come along with our adventure seekers and discover summer with Ford. Join friends Maisa and Leslie on an epic adventure with the capability of the Ford Bronco Sport. Head out with the Stevens family and stay connected with built-in Wi-Fi in the Ford Explorer.
Did you know that horses sleep standing up?
Road trip with the Sanchez family and available hands-free highway driving in the Ford F-150. Now get 2.9% financing for 60 months plus up to $4,500 cash back on select Ford SUVs. See your local Ford dealer and discover your best summer ever.
Welcome to today's segment of Talking Trades. I'm Ashley Rose, joined by Terry Newsom of the UA Local Union 72 Plumbers, Pipe Fitters, and HVACR Technicians. Now, Terry, earlier you told us that you've been with the trades for 30 years. How did you get into this?
30 years. So going back, my whole family does this. I'm the fourth generation on my dad's side coming through. And then my other side, both my grandfathers are actually members of Local 72. I actually graduated from Rockdale County High School in 1991 on a Friday night, and I was working on Monday morning, and I've never stopped.
Why do you think you've never stopped? Why do you think you've never left to do something else?
Because I love what I do, but also I show up every day. I do what I'm supposed to do. I go to work, and I work. So, 8 for 8.
And you say you love what you do. What are some projects you've worked on that you've loved over the years being able to get your hands in?
A lot of the data centers I've done, Atlantic Station, I worked on that before. I've done the chiller plant out there, just a lot of the stuff like that.
So you're always seeing new things.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yep, always moving around.
Now, what's your biggest piece of advice you give to someone kind of trying to decide, do I want to go the trades route, do I want to go the college routes, and what's the benefit of sticking with the trades?
Going the trades route, you go to school, you actually get to learn a skill trade. Nobody can take that away from you. That's always yours. And then just the benefits is great. I mean, show up, work, for every hour you work, you get benefits. Mm-hmm. So
Terry, we always talk about athletes being a great fit for the trades. If they don't go to the next level for their sport, why do you think their characteristics are so perfect for the trades?
Most of them are actually hard workers. Mm-hmm. They actually put in the time and the effort to get better. They work as a team, and that's what the local is about. We're all a big family. It's all one big team. So,
absolutely. Now, where can those go to find out more?
They could go to ua72.org, or they could call the office at 404-373-5778.
Terry, thanks so much for talking trades with us today. We will be back next week with more.
Great teams are committed, focused on the details, and work hard to be their best.
Planting season is here, and it's time to get your yard looking its best. So treat your yard to the perfect touch from the professionals at Personal Touch Lawn Care. Mowing, maintenance, design, and construction, Personal Touch Lawn Care does it all.
If my yard is taken care of, it's one thing off my list that I don't have to worry about.
Sign up now for monthly maintenance and get the 12th month free.
Big enough to serve you, small enough to know you.
Personal Touch Lawn Care, 770-908-1238 or online at ptlcatlanta.com.
What does it mean when people say America is a land of opportunity?
It means the power to discover.
To redefine yourself.
To improve yourself.
To challenge yourself.
To realize there's more in you
than you ever knew
that you could do.
It means giving people an open field to explore what they do best.
With the best tools.
The best training.
The best technology in the world.
We bring out the best in the people who serve.
So you can be all you can be.
And welcome back to the Sports Turf Halftime Show. I'm Kaylee Mansell, and for the second time in 2 weeks, I have the pleasure to interview the mayor of Rome, Miss Sunday Stevenson. So as I was driving into Rome today, I start seeing all of the election signs. What does election year look like for you?
Woo! Hectic.
Yes.
But it's putting together a good team and executing the plan. A lot of moving around town. A lot of saying, I'm Sunday Stevenson, and I appreciate your vote in November. But it's all good. It's worth it in the end when you know that you're in there. So I'm excited about it. Looking forward to it.
Well, I feel like the position that you're in, you have to have a lot of internal motivation. So what would you say drives your ambition?
I just like helping people. That was something that was instilled in me and my siblings by our parents when we were young. My father was in an accident, and he was left paralyzed. But he said, no matter what, you know, look around. There's always someone worse off than you. But he instilled in that in us to help others. And I enjoy helping. I like helping others. So that's part of it.
And I think that's very evident. You are very involved in the community, and you're a founding member of One Community United. What is the mission of that, and what has the community response to that been like?
Well, the community response has been great. One Community United is an organization. It came about because there was one man there. He was an attorney here in Rome. And after all the unrest from the Trayvon Martin and from everything that was happening in Ferguson and the other cities around, he said he did not want Rome. He loved Rome so much that he didn't want our city to end up like that. So he put out a request for people to come to lunch and let's talk about it. And there were 15 people that showed up. And from that, that One Community United was started. But what we found is that when we have a conversation with each other, that we have more in common than we do in different. So it's just about talking, getting to know one another. And that's what it's all about. In fact, on the third Sunday in this month in September, right on the John Ross Bridge, the footbridge, we have a dinner. It was called One Table, where we line up 6-foot tables all across the bridge, and we sit down and have a meal together. Wow. And you just talk, have a conversation with people that you normally wouldn't have a conversation with. Mm-hmm. But it's just getting to know one another, having a conversation, and knowing that we're all in this together, that we have the same hurts, or when you hurt, I hurt, that, you know, we're the same. We have more in common.
Well, I think that's very well said.
Well, thank you.
I want you to think decades from now, what is the legacy that you want to leave? What do you want to be known for, Ms. Stevenson?
That I cared about people. I cared about everybody. It doesn't matter if you're North Rome, South Rome, East Rome, West Rome, wherever. No matter what statue that you may have in the city, no matter that I care about you, that I cared about people, and that I cared about the well-being of people.
Well, I think that's very evident in the way you speak and the way that you carry yourself. So just thank you so much for being on with us yet again. It's such a pleasure to have you.
Well, thank you so much for having me, and thank you all for coming back to Rome.
You're
thank
very
you.
Welcome. All right, now we're going to toss to Brandon Adams up in the booth, who's about to interview someone. I'm so jealous he gets to do this. I hope you all enjoy it just as much as I do.
Thank you so much, Kaylee Manziel. And as you said, we have a very special guest here, John McClellan, more than 50 years being involved in high school football, and recently was bestowed a great honor. His name is now going to be affixed to the press box here along side another name here at Barron Stadium in Rome. How about this beautiful plaque to celebrate this going back to August the 8th, which happened to be my mom's birthday there as well. The Lee Mowry and John McClellan press box, the voices of Rome football. Mr. McClellan, thank you so much for spending some time with us. Congratulations and a great honor. What does it mean to you to have your career, your legacy here in the commitment you've made to football here at Barron Stadium remembered in such a way?
It was a tremendous honor, tremendous surprise. It was just a great surprise. I started doing this in 1999. This is my 25th year doing it. Obviously, I spent a lot of time in this press box for Rome High School, Rome Middle School, the JV, ninth grade, and even shorter football games. And I appreciate the honor.
So when you think about the great legacy of Rome playing here, games that you've been the PA announcer for, what kind of stand out to you as some of your best memories of the action you've seen right here on the field of Barron Stadium?
Well, obviously the 2016 and 2017 teams going to state championships. That 2016 team, we played 4 playoff games here at Barron Stadium, everything except the championship game. That 2017 team at that time, Langston Hughes broke it last year, but set the scoring record for Georgia. And getting to see all of those great players, almost 2016 and 27 championship teams, Knox Kadem, Jamias Griffin, Xavier Roberts, all those great talents off that team. But Rome's had a lot of good football teams over the years, reaching semifinals, reaching quarterfinals. One of the best games I saw here was a game Rome lost. Rome and Thompson in the quarterfinals back in 2002. Nothing in regulation. Rome lost in the old overtime system, and Thompson went on to win the state. But that game was a terrific game, even though it was 30 degrees outside.
And, of course, you're not just a PA announcer. You're also a local judge in the community. And, you know, when you think about here in Floyd County and the people of Rome, what does football mean to this community? And as someone who's had kind of the best seat in the house for so many years, How have you enjoyed watching the way that this particular town, this particular community interacts with the sport of high school football?
There's a lot of enthusiasm for football here. Not only Rome High School, but the county schools are Murchie and Coosa and Model and Pepperell, Darlington, Unity Christian. All of those teams have their fans. The fans turn out to support their teams and turn out with a lot of fervor. You have a lot of people who continue following these football games long after they're not directly involved in the school system. And on any given night, if one high school is not playing, you will have fans from that school going and visiting another local team.
Well, John McClellan, on behalf of everybody at Peachtree TV and Score Atlanta, congratulations on the great honor. Your name, a part of this press box here at Barron Stadium for a long time to come. Congratulations on that, and we'll take a quick timeout. We'll be right back right after this.
At Edmund Law, we understand that medical errors can lead to devastating results. That's why we fight for the compensation you deserve and hold those at fault accountable. Our highly reputable, experienced attorneys focus on catastrophic personal injury cases and have recovered over $100 million for our clients. And with my 12 years as a physician, I use that same bedside manner of caring to give you legal advice. Call now to schedule your free virtual consultation. The Edmund Firm, when I'm sorry is not enough.
America, come along with our adventure seekers, the Sanchez family, and discover summer with the Ford F-150. See how available features like Pro Trailer Backup Assist make backing up as easy as turning a knob. Watch as Pro Power On Board lights up the night. And Ford Blue Cruise makes driving even more fun. Now, get select Ford F-150 trucks with 3.9% financing for 60 months, plus get up to $2,500 cash back with your trade-in.
Life's better when you're under our roof. Because when you feel totally protected, you can enjoy the dreams you've worked so hard to achieve. Save up to 27% when you bundle home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote and find an agent at amfam.com.
Hey guys, how can I help you? Aren't you the Pinnacle Girl?
It's Pinnacle. It's Pinnacle.
Pinnacle Home Improvements is now offering zero down payment, zero interest, and zero payments for 12 months. Get a new roof installed, windows for your entire house, or new siding, and make it easy on yourself for a limited time only.
I can say it. It's Home Improvements.
We are back here live, Barron Stadium, Rome, Georgia. Carrollton on top of Rome, 13-0. Brandon Adams, Rusty Manziel. And, you know, when you look back at the first half, we saw in anticipation of the third and fourth quarter still on the way. I think you're going to see for both these teams kind of a story of what could have been, you know, opportunities that don't quite come together. And really a game in which both these teams still very much in. In fact, as we see our halftime stats here brought to you by the Mechanical Trades Institute. Rusty, what jumps out to you? What's the story of these first two quarters?
I think how good the Rome defense has played, but this has been a game of special teams and field position. Carrollton has capitalized twice inside the Rome 20, and Rome has went 0-for-2 inside the Carrollton 20 trying to get any points.
Have you ever seen the time of possession be as even as that?
That's crazy.
Almost exactly the same, 12:01 for Carrollton, 11:59 on the side for Rome, almost a full quarter of possession for both teams, and yet right now it's Carrollton's got that 13-0 lead. As Rusty said, block punt sets up touchdowns, and that's kind of the story here. As you kind of, you know, see the story right now. In fact, in just a moment, we're going to see our halftime highlights here, and you'll see more of that. That what Carrollton's been able to do is just connect with more of their kind of playmakers, and that's where the lead comes from, including a big performance by Kamari Farmer.
That's been the difference in the game right now. 14 carries for 108 yards, and he's been the difference maker in this entire game so far in the first half.
Of course, our halftime highlights are brought to you by Ford. And speaking of highlights, how about Caleb Odom, the Alabama commit? Those are the game's first points. But then it was more of Farmer after that.
Yeah, Farmer's been that guy. Odom is that mismatch. But look, you see Farmer right here. Look at him just put his foot in the ground. Great call coming out of a timeout. If you remember that, second touchdown of the game for Carrollton.
Yeah, Juju Lewis is a USC commit, but they're going to still try to find easy things for him when they can, including right there. And then at the end of the half, you know, the Rome defense had been so tough. But at the end of this half, it's the Carrollton defense that comes in, that plays dominantly. Kelly getting the sack. And it's really Rome, as you pointed out in the first half, reminiscent of the first time we saw him on television earlier this year, kind of stalling out with a drive on that same end zone right there at the end of the half. And that could have been a big difference maker in terms of momentum going into the third quarter.
You see them try different things. They go wildcat with Jaden Harmon. We saw that versus Cass. Didn't work there at the half. Didn't work this time. Fountain last time took a sack. The pressure got to him a little bit up the middle. So you want to see what they've done. The message for Rome has been great, I'm sure. Listen, we played well. We've got a score and we get a chance.
Once again, those halftime highlights brought to you by Ford, the man that Rusty mentioned, Reese Fountain. You saw him there on your screen. He's got a big task awaiting him here in the third quarter. Carrollton and Rome, second half action coming up. It's a drive for the GHSA state title, presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com here on Peachtree TV. And there is more football coming up right after this.
Man, you know how to do this?
Man, I don't even know. I was flipping burgers last week.
Violation, unsportsmanlike conduct, impersonating a craftsman.
Skilled trade unions are well-trained career pros, not part-timers. Construction is a rewarding and lucrative career with the advancement potential, but you have to do it the right way with the right training. Learn how you can be a pro. Find your career at GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com.
Planting season is here, and it's time to get your yard looking its best. So treat your yard to the perfect touch from the professionals at Personal Touch Lawn Care. Mowing, maintenance, design, and construction. Personal Touch Lawn Care does it all.
If my yard is taken care of, it's one thing off my list that I don't have to worry about.
Sign up now for monthly maintenance and get the 12th month free.
Big enough to serve you, small enough to know you.
Personal Touch Lawn Care, 770-908-1238 or online at ptlcatlanta.com.
America, it's time to gear up and get out there in a new Ford vehicle. And it all starts at your local Ford dealer during the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need to discover your best summer ever. With a large inventory in stock, now is the best time to trade in, trade up, and discover summer with Ford. Now get 2.9% financing for 60 months plus up to $4,500 cash back on select Ford SUVs. See your local Ford dealer and discover your best summer ever.
The drive for the GHSA state title is presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com. Transform your future today.
And we are back. Start of the third quarter on the way. The tropical attire here for the Rome student section. We see a different theme with student attire each week. And the tropical attire, although not quite tropical weather necessarily today. Not as hot as it's been at least. Brandon Adams, Rusty Manziel back with you.
I might be a little more Jimmy Buffett.
Yeah.
Layered up there.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
They got Floyd County DNA. Little Jimmy Buffett up here goes a long way.
Hey, I've got no problem with that either. So, Rome going to kick things away here. It'll be Gary Wright on for the duties. Excuse me, Jason Cruz Reyes. We'll get the chance here. Carrollton leads 13-0. Glad to have you with us tonight on Peachtree TV. Cruz Reyes' kick is low, bouncing. Field at 25. Now running 30. 36-yard line. And down goes Jordan White. So Carrollton with the lead and the football to begin things here in the third quarter. And the Rome defense, which has been so good all night long, will need to be good again. And speaking of so good to see those scores rolling by underneath us, presented by Breda Pest Vantage, including right down the road here, Cartersville all over to Alatoona.
That's
by the tune of 37-0.
Surprising game there to me. Cartersville really flexing right there. And that with Creekview over Calhoun. Creekview will play Rome later in the season.
Impressed with what we saw from Calhoun last week, of course.
Yeah, they bounced back big time with that big win over Carver.
Juju throwing. It's Odom on the sideline. And he's into Rome territory.
Yeah, you can tell Joey King came out of the half and said, I'm going to get number 7 the ball. He wasted no time getting him. That was a strike by Julian Lewis there to hit his Alabama wide receiver commit.
Caleb Odom.
So that's kind of the debate, too. You're going to call him the wide receiver. Some people kind of wonder, is he the detached, you know, tight end? Is he the wide receiver? Well, he's a pass catcher extraordinaire for sure. Juju kind of sidearms that one, and it's complete. And it's inside the 10-yard line, Ryan Mosley.
Yeah, you see what makes Julian Lewis so special. You see him change the arm angle there. It was his second read. He was going to dump this ball off right there, and he flips his hips and throws a strike. And Carrollton is on the move in a hurry right here, Brandon.
I've told you before, I don't consider myself a scout, but the thing I always notice when a quarterback throws it easily, makes it look easy, and Lewis certainly made it look easy that time. Red Zone presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com. Here is Farmer. Left side, makes a man miss, and then he's going to fight down near the goal line.
Man.
He took a hit and then just shook it off.
Watch the good word of the year, contact balance. Watch this shot. Bam, stays up. Look, another one stays up, keeps his legs driving.
Yeah, that was Hester in on defense who delivered the hit. And as Rusty said, you see the numbers for Farmer on the night.
Man, he is.
Whew. He's also got a touchdown through the air. Keep that in mind. Ball now rests at the 5.
They scored on this play earlier, 21 at the top.
Second down, throwing that way. It's Farmer, got his block, and got his second touchdown of the night.
Exact same play in the exact same end zone. They go right back to it, and man, did Carrollton come out of the half and answer very quickly with a touchdown.
That is what they're capable of doing. We saw a moment ago, or in the first half, this formation turned into a fake that they were just a little too quick on the trigger on. Hernandez is 1-for-1 on PA attempts tonight. More of a traditional look now. Up 19 and trying to make it an even 20. Out of the gates, the third quarter, and it's blocked. And that can't be returned. Harmon, the terrific junior linebacker, got his paws on that. So a little bit of a salvation for Rome after.
Man, he blew that guard up. Look at that leaping job right there. Great job by Adams.
So we will take a quick break. Carrollton comes firing quick, gets the touchdown. The lead is 19, and Rome gets a response for the first time in the second half after this.
You don't have to wake up on the right side of the bed to know how you like your coffee. As long as it's McCafe coffee from Mickey D's. Now that's what you like.
Mix and match two breakfast hits for $4.49. Add any size iced coffee for $1.79. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Sometimes it's the little victories that mean the most. At Ingles, we know there's no one you'd rather share those miniature memorable moments with than family. Ingles, all the ingredients for family.
At Edmund Law, we understand that medical errors can lead to devastating results. That's why we fight for the compensation you deserve and hold those at fault accountable. Our highly reputable, experienced attorneys focus on catastrophic personal injury cases and have recovered over $100 million for our clients. And with my 12 years as a physician, I use that same bedside manner of caring to give you legal advice. Call now to schedule your free virtual consultation. The Edmund Firm, when I'm sorry is not enough.
It's back. Come join the fun at the Athens Fair, August 31st through September 4th at the Greater Athens Fairgrounds. Bring the whole family out for a fun-filled day of one-of-a-kind rides like Carnage and Skydiver. There's something for everyone, including the circus, a petting zoo, live music, and all your favorite fair foods. On September 4th, join us for a special event, the Spanish Heritage Festival. Tickets at the gates are just $10 for adults and $5 for kids. See you at the Athens Fair, August 31st through September 4th at the Greater Athens Fairgrounds.
The GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com drive for the GHSA state title is sponsored by the Mechanical Trades Institute, the best-kept secret everyone should know about. Smart Local 85, sheet metal is a smart move. Gatorade, fuel tomorrow. The Georgia Sheet Metal and Air Conditioning Contractors Association, careersinsheetmetal.com, building a solid future. The Atlanta Falcons, rise up, Dirty Birds. and by the Gwinnett County Sheriff's Office. Together, we can make a difference.
Carrollton adds another touchdown. Kamari Farmer's second of the night. PAT block, and that's our score. Rome cheerleaders, though, not dissuaded by any of that. They're still making a bunch of noise and having a really good time. But their Wolves classmates need some points right now. Julian Vargas will kick it high, short and returnable. Fieldable inside the 10. And then DK Daniel going to get up near the 20-yard line. We'll see our scoring summary brought to you by Breda Pest Management. A lot of Julian Lewis on that last drive. Finally with the strike to Farmer for the touchdown. Four plays, 65 yards. Nice catch for Odom near the sideline. Also opened it up to 57 seconds off the clock. That was a pretty fast-paced, action-packed sequence for the Trojans.
You saw the two best throws of the night for Julian Lewis, and you saw why people think he potentially could be the number one high school football player in the country because of the position he plays. But that first ball to start the second half to Caleb Odom in that hole, cover two, between that safety and corner, then he comes right back and throws that arm angle, just flick of the wrist. And like you said, Brandon, he makes it look easy. That's not easy of a play. And Carrollton strikes quick and early in the third quarter.
So Fountain now from the shotgun, going to hand it off. That's McDermott. McDermott gets up to about the 25, may have gotten about four that time. Second down coming up.
Plenty of time here. Rome can stay within their game plan. They want to run the ball. Nice gain of 4 yards on first down.
Keep in mind, a lot of backstory between these two teams as Fountain's going to keep it, and he got blasted that time. C.J. Gamble, the linebacker, one of the guys in on that stop. Fountain took a pretty big hit.
Yeah, he took a shot right there. He pulls it, man. They just slammed him to the turf.
And really did.
Yep.
That's going to bring a third down. The point that I was making before the Fountain hit was, you know, John Reed doesn't hold back in saying that the long history between Carrollton and Rome, these are two teams, he says, they don't like each other very much. Intense rivalry among the fan bases as Fountain may have drawn a Carrollton player offsides.
Joey King is not going to like that. You go from third and six now to third and one. See if they change the play up. They're going to substitute. Yep, they're going to bring in a full, bring in an extra running back, it looks like. Going to bring in.
Yeah, that's Kendall Wright running into the game. That's a starting linebacker who also plays fullback, too. And you see our Gordo's cheesy play of the game with Reese Fountain. And we've seen that a lot this year, the veteran quarterback, the hard count cadence, the clap. And that's enough to draw folks off sides. And little Gordo's cheese dip sounds pretty good right now, too. Fountain going to keep it on third down, though, and going to be met in the backfield.
Didn't get it.
Did not get it.
Nope.
And that's going to force guard high back out to punt again.
Great job right there on the defensive end by Carrollton, number 15. Quintus Adams squeezes down. Makes Fountain take that read to keep it, and he comes back and tackles him for a loss.
Guard high gets the high punt away. He's had a couple of touch tonight, one outright block to turn into a touchdown, but he got a high punt away that time. And, you know, Rusty, I think you got to circle that play right there. And you say, okay, you got third and one after after the penalty, and then you're not able to convert that. That's going to be one of those that you're going to really, really be paying close attention to.
If you got any chance, Brandon, to get back in this, you got to move the chains. If nothing less, you got to keep your offense on the field right now. Give them a chance. But that play was made by Adams. He squeezed down. Fountain made the right read, but Adams was athletic enough to come back and get him for a loss there. And tough when you can't get a yard.
Juju, handoff. It's been a lot of Farmer today. He's up to the 39. He got seven on first down, and for everything the Rome defensive line has been able to do, they're starting to have less and less answers for Farmer.
I'll tell you what, it was a great block by Cole Norrin, number 70. He took his defender, 98, Justin Terrell, and just pushed him right past the gap. And you see big 70 there with a nice block and opened up that lane for Farmer.
8:30, third quarter of play. Here's Juju to throw, sideline route. Mosley was there, but incomplete.
Brandon, this is a big series right here because you gave up a touchdown right off the bat to start the third quarter. You really don't have a ton of momentum offensively. Carrollton seems like they're in a little bit of a flow. You got a third and three. You got a great opportunity to get off the field with potentially some good field position right here. And you better know where number seven is on a third and three.
Yeah, he's going to be on the left, the right side of the formation. That's the very bottom of your screen, the Alabama commit. Juju looks other way, though. Pass caught. Still on his feet. First down yardage for Kyan Kofer. And that moves the chains for Carrollton.
Got a flag down
there
right here.
There's a flag, though.
That might be holding out on the perimeter. I think they were holding number one, Jaden Harmon. Look right here. Yeah, you see that? See that jersey right there, 87? Yep.
Yeah.
We'll call that every time.
Yeah.
Now, he's being physical with him, but you got to let go of that jersey. You got to be able, he's got to be able to make attempt at a tackle, and that's a huge penalty right there against Carrollton, who would have moved the chains, Brandon.
Holding.
Okay, so we're going to replay third down. And, you know, this becomes a much bigger deal now because Rome going to show three defensive linemen up front. Juju with time. Rolling left, now just has to throw it out of bounds. And so after the penalty, Rome gets the benefit of now forcing a fourth down.
Listen, smart play there by a young quarterback. You do not want to force that. The play's not there. You live for another play. You don't force that ball into coverage. And that's a quarterback right there. Some people are like, hey, he didn't make a play. He did the only thing he could do. Now his team can punt and play defense, but that's a very smart play. Great job defensively by Rome, but also a smart play by a young quarterback just to throw that away and live for another play.
Yeah, it's the oldest football cliche in the world, but end every drive with a kick.
No doubt.
Either a PAT, a punt, speaking of punt, low punt, wobbly, rolling, return man for Rome, wise to get out of the way, and ends up being really not all that bad.
That would drive you nuts if you're Rome, because the guy just punted one about the height of 6 foot and it rolled 60 yards.
On Friday, September 8th, something really fun happening here in the Rome area. It's Chapel Heart live in concert. It's an American country music vocal group. It was featured on the popular contest show America's Got Talent. Now you can make your plans to see Chapel Heart live in concert at the Rome City Auditorium on Friday, September the 8th. Purchase tickets online today at www.romega.us/tickets. You can also scan the QR code right there on your screen if you'd like to learn more about that. So Rome had to have that defensive stop, and it got it. But can it come up with the kind of drive that's eluded it thus far? Fountain will throw, try to dump it off to McDermott, but that pass was a little short.
See, he's looked out of rhythm since about the midway through second quarter. He's just been out of rhythm a little bit.
And it doesn't, I mean, obviously he's facing a tough Carrollton defense, but it doesn't seem particularly spurred on by anything Carrollton's doing, at least that I can see.
I tell you what, I was told at halftime he took a shot last week to his right arm, and you see a little bit of that tonight, Brandon. Okay. He doesn't have that live arm that we've watched for 4 years, and maybe that's impacting him a little bit.
He will run, trying to buy some time. Now he has to run. Flag comes in there as well. He's out of bounds up near the 38, but let's watch this flag. It's obviously in a problematic area if you're a Rome fan.
Good job here getting out of the pocket.
I believe you may have seen it right there on your screen.
Yes, it came past.
Those darn TV cameras.
I mean, those TV cameras are rough for moms.
Those TV cameras, the eye in the sky doesn't lie, unfortunately.
I was watching the podcast from the Kelsey brothers, and they were talking about NFL linemen will wear the same color jersey as the glove, so you can't see the holding.
Half the distance to the goal, replay second down.
And that's actually really interesting.
I never thought of that.
Yeah.
He said that the Patriots, of all teams.
Of all teams.
I mean, shocker. The Patriots kind of taught you to wear the gloves the same color as opposing jersey. Can't really see you hold them.
And really, in high school, the telltale sign of the hold is when the play moves in the direction
yes.
and the lineman can't go that way.
Yes.
That's always the telltale sign.
Yep.
Here's Fountain. going to have to hurry again. They took another hit again and was lucky to get rid of that.
Well, they're getting after him right now. They're bringing extra defensive players and really have got Rome just – they're kind of just off balance all together right now. You can't really run, not able to throw the ball with some consistency right now, and you end up with a very long third and 24 right here. Probably going to be a screen play, something easy, see if you can pop something.
McDermott is your running back. He has been in for the duration since the Chance Arthur injury in our first half. Carrollton defensive back creeps towards the line. They're going to look McDermott's way. Instead, they're going to throw complete to Stallings. Stallings not even back to the original line of scrimmage. So this drive not going anywhere for Rome right now.
That's who I think. They've got to get him involved. We saw him against Cass. Watch the burst on him a little bit. Just tripped up there, but really haven't been to his side most of the night. So I think as the game goes on, they got to get Stallings involved.
Corey guard high back out to punt again. Be careful if you're Rome. Carrollton's blocked one, touched another, and those have resulted in points. Guard high, when he gets it away, it is high. And this one's high, but returnable. 40, 45, up to the 47, and down, Keyshawn Johnson. No relation, by the way, to the former wide receiver, not spelled the same way either, but
he limps off. Make a note, number 9 limped off for Carrollton.
All right, let's watch that and we'll give you an update coming back. Carrollton's got the football. They're up 19 here on Peachtree TV.
What's so great about being a Kroger Boost member? Free delivery on the Kroger products you love and more rewards too, like double fuel points on everything you buy. Experience a new level of membership, starting as low as $59 a year with Boost by Kroger Plus. Learn more at Kroger.com today.
Are you 18 years of age or older? Become a star. The Gwinnett County Sheriff's Office is now hiring for deputy sheriff with a signing bonus up to $4,700. They also have civilian and trades positions available. If you are interested in a career with the Gwinnett County Sheriff's Office, visit gogcso.com to learn more about compensation, incentives, benefits, and areas where you can start your career today. Are you ready to rise to the call? Join GCSO today and become a star.
More football coming up in a moment. Third quarter scorer, Carrollton on top of Rome, but obviously big recruits in this game and maybe some not getting enough of attention. Let's do that right now with a Georgia Elite Classic recruiting report presented by Dog Nation.
Yeah, you look at number 48 right there, Trayvon Adams, senior defensive lineman. I'm telling you something about him. He's 6'2", 250. Okay, he might not be an SEC Power 5 type, but I can tell you right now, there's a lot of schools he can play for that play on Saturdays, and I think his tape from the last couple of weeks are going to really help him. And then you look at number 21 for Carrollton. You know, this kind of no name that's come out of nowhere, Kamari Farmer. And I'll tell you this, the people that are watching tonight going, man, they're not going to miss Bryce. Listen, Bryce Hicks is one of the best players in the country, period. But this young man right here is making his own name, and this is a big statement tonight for this young man. Sophomore running back standing beside, oh, by the way, that sophomore quarterback in Julian Lewis.
Tight end Jordan White goes in motion. Pop pass by Lewis, and it's a strike to Odom, and Odom's inside the 30-yard line.
Yeah, do you see the zip on that ball? I mean, that ball came out of his hands. Watch him how quick this ball gets on, and it hits Odom right in the pocket where he's running. Almost impossible to defend with that size. And I tell you, Juju Lewis threw for 33 yards in the first half, and that probably didn't set well with him either.
No. Keep in mind, this is a team that's without Bryce Hicks, one of their outstanding players. running back, pass catching threat, entering the first game. And what I'm seeing right now is a team that does not look like it's missing too much of a beat, with all due respect to Hicks, who's a guy you could play virtually any position you wanted to, including on defense. Flag down, by the way. And as we wait, I'll, you know, bring this up, and you see it's going to go against Carrollton. You know, some of the Carrollton folks were here were telling us before the game that, hey, you know, if it's a big defensive play, that's a spot that Hicks would have also been in as well. He would have been on the field defensively.
100%. You know, when we asked John Reed about it, and obviously he said, look, what makes Hicks so dangerous is he can impact the game, kick, punt return, running back, wide receiver, and DB.
Yeah.
I think he scored at every position last year, but certainly, listen, this Farmer, this sophomore running back.
Ooh. Speaking of quarterbacks, too, Brady Passman is a score ticker. You see Buford on top of North Cobb right now. North Cobb hanging around that game a little bit, but a big night so far for Dylan Raiola.
Yeah, they got pretty viral pretty quick. You're going to see I showed you during the timeout. It was a 60-yard pass by Dylan Raiola, and one of those passes, Brandon, you go, that doesn't look normal.
No.
That doesn't look normal.
It looks like the kind of thing a five-star quarterback would have done.
That's when you're on the opposing side and you sit there and you talk about that. I'm going to tell you about that play in about 10 years because I was sitting there. I watched Trevor Lawrence make that throw many a night.
And plus, you talk about, you know, Juju's first half stat line maybe not sitting well with him. I'm certainly not here to tell you that Raiola's played poorly through two games, but against tough competition, you know, Buford, a team that likes to run the ball, maybe not quite as eye-popping a stat line as maybe some thought Raiola might have.
Yep.
I'd say he's correcting some of that here tonight. Lewis now showing his feet, but he's going to get hit from behind, and he's going to go down.
Yeah, good job, Ben. You see Justin Terrell, the NC State commit. And I'll tell you, they're down 19 points, but that front four from Rome, they're not giving up. And they are giving Juju Lewis right now some problems.
And let's give credit here. You know, this is a group that a year ago would have had a guy like Stephylin Green and went on his way to Clemson. I mean, it's not easy to lose a Clemson-level defensive lineman and continue to play at the defensive line level the way they are right now. John Reed told us this week, he said, I knew our defensive line was going to open some eyes. He's obviously the head coach who coaches the defensive line, and that's a group he's very proud of.
And let me just say after this play, blitz.
Third down, Lewis throwing again. Oh, and he put it right in there, but not quite able to connect with A.J. McNeil.
Great job right there by Joe Wilkinson, 22, the Appalachian State commit. You see him, that ball hung up just a second, and you saw Wilkinson close right here at the end. Watch him flash across the screen, stick his right arm out.
It's kind of one of those tight window throws that you kind of like.
That's a big leak throw. I'll say this too now. Rome lost two Division I prospects off their defense, and Alto Moore and Martavius Collins. Both of them transferred up into Tennessee. So they lost two Division I players that would have been here tonight. Both transferred up and are playing their senior years up in the state of Tennessee. Martavius Collins, an Auburn commit.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Another one of those low, wobbly punts that takes a nice roll. And while I have your attention, we'll remind you about our friends at Brady Pass Management here once again, because nobody wants unwanted guests taking up residence in their homes. And as we sometimes jokingly say, I'm not talking about your in-laws here. I'm talking about bugs and critters and things like that, because when it comes to keeping those critters out of your house, just one company to call, and that's my friends at Brady Pass Management, big supporters of Georgia high school football and a big part of our drive to GHSA state title. So thank you to Brady Pass Management for being a part of everything that goes on with Georgia high school athletics.
Big day tomorrow, Brandon.
Looking forward to it. Week one, college football season.
I don't think we would be doing our job if we didn't mention Sonny Seiler and his family.
Yes.
Long time connected to the University of Georgia.
The legendary figure that started the tradition of UGA at the University of Georgia. And by the way, as the whistle blows in the end zone, also, I know it's been a big celebration around here all day long. Penalty goes against Rome, but our great colleague Ashley Carey had her baby.
How about that? Man.
We're thrilled for her, of course. Baby Charlotte has arrived, and we are so happy about that.
In true Rosenberg fashion, she spent about 3.5 days, and they had to just come get her.
I love it. Fountain now from the shotgun, and he is square in his own end zone. Lonely place to be. trying to hard count to see if he can buy himself a little bit more room. Play clock's down to five.
Gotta hurry.
Gets it off. Fountain's gonna throw it deep from the end zone. Hester is there and he catches it. Big play near midfield. And maybe that's the spark that Rome needs to get things going.
Man, what a throw by Fountain from his end zone. I kept thinking, man, he's going to step on that line. Hester does a great job. Look at him just reel that ball in right there. And he catches that over Cameron McClure. Great throw and catch by Rome. And you said it, Brandon, maybe that's the spark they needed.
Here comes Fountain again, but it's incomplete. Not able to hold on that time. First target of the day for Brajon Jackson. And it's incomplete, and that'll bring up second down.
I tell you what, you don't get many targets, and you don't want to at least see him pat himself, and that young man knows I should have had that junior wide receiver. Man, Fountain hit him right there in the hands and dropped it.
To go back to the completion to Hester a moment ago, best ball that Fountain's thrown all night, right?
Yeah, that was on the money for about almost 50.
Three receivers left side. They become blockers for McDermott, but big play in the backfield. Kelvin Hill, the cornerback, meets McDermott for a lost yardage.
Yeah, Coach King told us they were ready for that. They knew a lot of screen, a lot of underneath, a lot of perimeter throws, and they were ready for that this week, and certainly have seen that. Big third and 13 here.
It's going to be split receivers, two on each side, three down linemen for Carrollton. Whistle blows, play stops before it starts. And that's because Carrollton wants to talk it over with a timeout.
Yeah, they didn't like the formation, how they were lined up. Coaches were talking. There was confusion on the sideline based off how Rome was lined up.
And while we have a moment, let me remind you that group ticket packages are available now for the Atlanta Falcons home games. You can learn more about options for youth sports teams, client hosting events, and so much more. It's AtlantaFalcons.com/tickets for details.
What is Falcons football? It's Grady putting quarterbacks on notice. It's Kyle shredding defenses like a unicorn. It's Tyler breaking tackles like phone screens. It's AJ locking down anyone on his island. It's Drake touching the sun. It's CP breaking another record. What is Falcons football? It's all you dirty birds. Rise up.
And welcome back. And, you see the series history here. Carrollton leads all time 5-4. Also won a year ago 23-6.
Let me give you a little asterisk at the bottom of that. You see those green and white state championships underneath that press box?
Uh-huh.
West Rome went 59-1 in 4 years. The one loss was 7-0 to the Carrollton Trojans in 1984.
So a lot of history here.
It goes back a long ways. I can assure you it's more than nine games history in this stadium.
A lot of fun there. Fountain with pressure. Gets it to Hester. Complete.
That's good enough. 42-yard line. That's good enough where they can go for that. Big completion there for about 10? They got fourth and three,
fourth and two about. They're going to hurry up the line on fourth down. They are not showing any hesitation. Carrollton creeps a couple of extra guys up front. Pass going to be complete to Daniel. Daniel gets it and stays on his feet, and he's still on his feet down the sidelines for a touchdown.
Wow.
And Rome is on the board.
What an answer right there. 41 yards on fourth and two, and Daniels did all that, breaking tackles, got up the field, and that is what Rome needed to get back in this game.
Stays on his feet right there. And he was on his way. 42 yards on the touchdown.
What a drive by Rome. 99 yards.
It's a mishandle on the PAT. Ball is free. Now it's just dead. You can't return that in Georgia high school football. So we've seen a couple of miscues now for PATs. But what matters if you're a Rome fan is you finally find that elusive touchdown.
Yeah. 99-yard drive right there, Brandon. Rome was backed up in the end zone. And a big play was that chunk play. But watch D.K. Daniel run through a couple of arm tackles. I think Carrollton thought he was going down.
Yep. Breda pest management scoring summary. Five plays, 98 yards, 77 seconds off the top, off the clock. DK Daniels.
Great answer there by Rome. Get right back in this thing. Plenty of time. They can stay within their game.
This has not been the highest scoring game that we've seen, but it's been a thriller, I think. And I believe it's still anybody's game. Here's still left to go.
Physical. Physical football game. We knew it would be.
You see John Reed there, the veteran coach. Back-to-back state championships in 2016, 2017.
I said this many times. That 2017 team, when they smelled blood in the water, it was over. One of the most ferocious defenses and the all-time scoring offense.
Short kick, fielded by White. Uh-oh. And the football came free. Rome thinks it has it. They're going to say he's down, though.
They're calling it down.
They're going to say he's down. Emphatic call. Let's see on the replay. It's Jordan White on the return.
Yeah, he's down.
Yeah, ground caused that fumble. Yep. Good call by the officials who were there, and they called it quickly and loudly.
Yep.
Unmistakable by the vantage point of that replay.
And a great job by that official, not letting any hesitation make that call. Good job.
All right, so Juju back out here, the USC quarterback commit, just a sophomore, as you know. Rome showing four across on that defensive front. Hand off to Farmer. He's been big today, a couple touchdowns, but he's got nowhere to go on that one. Second out coming up, you see. Terrell coming up happy after.
Tell you what, man, NC State fans are excited about him. Watch him come. Watch him 98 right here. Come. Watch him come off his block, scrape down right here.
Ooh,
that's a great job. He was on the other side of the ball.
Absolutely nothing on first down. That makes it second and 10. Juju to Farmer again. In the backfield, shakes free though. Fights up to about the 44.
Man, he's tough. He is tough, Brandon. They have him twice hemmed up. Watch right here, got him there. Spins out of that, fakes him off, stiff arm, and you see Big 98 look at the hustle on him, but man, Farmer, what a night.
Love the lateral.
Oh, yeah.
Love the lateral quickness. You see big numbers. Third down now. Farmer again. Heavy dosage of him. He takes a big hit, but stays on his feet. And I believe he's going to get it. He is right there on the line. They're going to move the chains for him. Yep. He took a big hit and got the first down for his troubles.
Now look at the vision on him. You know what I see when I see him is he's got two more years of high school football.
Mm-hmm.
You're seeing someone explode on the scene tonight against a very talented Rome defense.
Juju will throw, dump off to Farmer, took a big hit, incomplete. I mean, he was met and with bad intentions by Antoine Carey, the senior cornerback.
Great job, and what I'll say for Farmer is he didn't really fall down too much.
Yeah.
I mean, watch this hit. He absorbs this hit. Watch this. Just kind of bounces off there. Great job by the Rome defensive back to close there.
Yeah, I can promise you if I got hit in a defensive spot like that, I'd take a six-month sabbatical.
The good thing, the reason the hospital's over behind the stadium, because they would be wheeling Rusty Mansell over there right now for that shot.
Farmer acted like he barely even felt it.
Man.
Odom, the Alabama commit, that's number seven, standing right there on the five of the 50-yard line, bottom of your screen. Here is Farmer, left side, trying to get a block. Going to fight forward. Going to make it third and very manageable coming up.
Man,
under a minute in the third quarter.
Tough, Brandon. I mean, he just, I don't know what he weighs, but he runs like he weighs 190, 195. Because people just bounce off of him.
started the year as a backup. Many of you are aware of that. If you've been with us all night, you've heard us speak it before. Bryce Hicks, the terrific player, injured in that thrilling season opener for Carrollton against 6A defending state champion Langston Hughes.
Third down and three. Got to think this might be two down territory for Joey King.
Tight end in motion. Hand off to Farmer. Farmer, first down yardage. 35 down to about the 31. And that's going to move the chains for Carrollton again. This drive starting to pick up some steam.
I'm telling you right now, you're starting to see some fatigue in the Rowan defense. See some guys, hands on seat, they're just kind of, those big guys are just kind of out of gas, even though they're making plays, but they've been on the field for a long time. They'll get a chance for a breather right here.
Yeah, the fourth quarter going to be on its way. Third quarter concludes. Rome gets the score, but Carrollton trying to answer back. It is still anybody's ball game, and every play is going to matter over the final 12 minutes. What a way to start our drive for the GHSA state title. And we'll be right back with fourth quarter action right after this.
The Peachtree TV Friday Night Game of the Week. Milton versus Roswell. Next Friday at 8. High school football on Peachtree TV. Atlanta's own CW. Sponsored locally by these sponsors.
Every morning, we get you ready for everything.
We're ready to help you plan.
The first to show you what's next.
Ready to break important news.
Our community is better when we're better informed.
Atlanta News First. Every morning, ready for everything.
It's good! Heat! Good! Go! All the way!
At Ingles, we're proud to partner with area athletics. From Little League to the pros, college tournaments to high school heroes, it's all in the bag.
You ready? Hold on, let me check the score.
Ingles, low prices, love the savings.
You don't have to wake up on the right side of the bed to know how you like your coffee. As long as it's McCafe coffee from Mickey D's. Now that's what you like.
Mix and match two breakfast hits for $4.49. Add any size iced coffee for $1.79.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Severe weather. Atlanta's no stranger to it. Power outages, flooded streets, hail damage. We've seen it all.
That's why Atlanta News First has the largest team of meteorologists in the entire Southeast.
To keep you ready for anything, this is why we first alert.
And we are back. Fourth quarter, getting ready to get underway. Carrollton on top of Rome, 19-6. Brandon Adams, Rusty Mansell. Good look there at the Rome Wolf sideline. First and 10 now for Carrollton. Juju Lewis, USC quarterback commit. Hand off to Ja'Kari Farmer, who's had what can only be described as a breakout performance here today.
Yeah, he's been outstanding. And he's getting better as the game goes on. And he's not the biggest drink of water right now. Look at him. But, man, he just runs through the first tackle, Brandon. He turns 3 yards into five or six.
He has two of Carrollton's three touchdowns. And you see the rushing total, 148 yards.
Better watch Odom right here at the bottom of the screen.
Mismatch there from a size standpoint, but it's going to be a sack instead. Parco Smith, junior linebacker, brings Lewis to the ground.
That's where he was trying to go, but he had pressure in his face. You see him look to the left. He's going to throw this ball to Odom. See him looking that way. But the linebacker, now that's where the Farmer, the young running back, has got to step up. You got to put your face into that linebacker. That's something Joey King, I don't care how many yards he has tonight, he's going to show him that play because you're going to get our quarterback sacked. You got to be able to take on that. They call it Bob, back on backer. You got to be able to make that Bob block.
That makes third down long now. I have a third and 14. Probably two down territory. Lewis, quick strike to Odom. Odom looking for his block down to the 25. Going to be about, what, 2 yards short of the first down here?
Yeah, and the way the special teams have been tonight, I certainly think they're going for this.
I'm imagining they'll just keep him on there and not even hesitate.
I believe we got a player down.
Player down.
Carrollton.
Yeah, that's
78.
Yeah, that's God Gift Dudley. That's one of the captains for today's game. That's a senior left tackle, one of the Carrollton captains. He's walking off on his own, but he's walking off slowly.
Yeah. Like the name, God Gift. God Gift Dudley.
Really nice. Good night so far for this Carrollton offensive line. Of course, many of you are aware, in addition to Dudley, who's had a good night. Zakai Helton there in the middle, the sophomore center. He's also an Alabama commit.
You got to think on fourth and two, you're going to get a dose of 21.
You would have to think it. Now, do they do it through the air? Do they do it on the ground? Because he's been pretty effective both ways.
He is in the power eye right now.
Yeah,
they motion
power
him.
Set. Now, watch him Farmer going to become
wing
in motion.
Speed sweep.
Take the handoff. Going to try to cut back towards the inside.
I don't think he got there. Unless they give him the spot. He didn't get it.
Yeah, he didn't get there. He's well short. May have even lost a yard.
Yep.
And Rome gets a big stop.
Yeah, they go power eye there, motion out of it, and try to get him the ball with a little inside handoff sweep right here. Great job by Rome scraping that. You see 48 with the initial push, and then Wilkinson comes in with a few other Rome defenders to stop him and give him a chance. 10 minutes to go, down two touchdowns.
So let me tell you what I saw, and you tell me if you agree. It didn't necessarily seem like Rome had that play necessarily just sniffed out from the beginning. They just had great pursuit and followed Farmer to the point.
They won the line of scrimmage at the point of attack.
All right. So Rome needs a drive here. About 10 minutes in our game. Fountain dumps off to McDermott. McDermott finds the edge, and he's heading down the sideline. And he's still on his feet. No, he went out of bounds.
Wow.
But not before he gets a big game.
Sir.
All right, let's see here. Rome fans are booing. I think they're.
Oh, man.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my goodness.
They're going to bring this way back.
Wow.
And there is a very nice video board here at Barron Stadium.
Oh, my
fans
goodness.
Are seeing some images they don't agree with.
Oh, man.
This one comes way back.
Brandon, that would have been a touchdown.
Yeah.
I don't know what they're – I mean, he's
– on that image right there, we don't see a foot touch the out-of-bounds. Pressure coming on Fountain. And he's going to – oh! And it's Stalling stays on his feet.
Big hit. Listen, you got to put that play past you. You got to move on. I know the fans here are upset. They blew that call, okay? But you can't deal with that right now. You have got to go on. It's second and 12, Brandon. 9 minutes to go, down 13.
Unusual in a high school stadium to see immediate, you know.
Yeah, you have video replay.
Replay.
Yep.
But here at Rome, they do have it, and their fans saw it, and the players did there as well. Here's Fountain going to have to try to hurry. Gets rid of it, and it's intercepted. It's going to go all the way back for a score for Camarion McClure. Cameron McClure, the cornerback. Fountain threw it up for grabs. McClure was there, and the junior brings it back for a score.
Yeah, you cannot just float that ball up, trying to make something out of nothing right there. See him scrambling, throws off his back foot, gets hit. Ball just sails on him, and Carrollton takes that one to the house. And Brandon, that series is going to be a talk of what ifs, because you had a play before, two plays before that was likely a touchdown, call back, and two plays later, Carrollton scores on a pick six.
Man, what a shift in momentum for where it was. And obviously, Rome fans are going to tell their side of that story for a while. New score now, 25-6. And we were heading for something quite different than that, it certainly seemed. Carlos Hernandez made his last two PATs after missing his first. And now it's 26-6 after the Cameron McClure pick six interception for a touchdown. Trojans trying to be the first team to win on the road in Rome since 2021. Stay with us, everybody.
Dang, where you get this car?
You need to join the union.
The union?
Absolutely. You can get 10 of these.
Union construction workers earn the highest wages with the best benefits and the most protection in the construction industry. Find your career in construction. Go to GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com and start your future today.
Hendrick.
Drive now, pay later. Shop HendrickCars.com this month and make no payments for 90 days. Over 20,000 new and pre-owned vehicles. No payments for 90 days. Visit HendrickCars.com.
My marriage kind of took a different path. He told me he was not moving back into the home. My biggest fear was the unknown. What would happen with the children and myself? What would happen with the house? I found Meriwether and Tharp. They told me that they would walk me through this divorce, and they did that tenfold. You need an attorney. You need the best attorney, and that's going to be Meriwether and Tharp.
Great teams are committed, focused on the details, and work hard to be their best. From practice to games, right down to their gear, your field is a critical part of the game that allows your athletes to showcase their abilities. Sports Turf is committed to bringing your team innovative sports surfaces with unparalleled performance. You bring the vision, our team brings it to life.
All right, welcome back, everybody. Here's what happened a moment ago. It's our game's key defensive stop presented by the Gwinnett County Sheriff's Department. And Reese Fountain's made a lot of great throws tonight and during his career. Maybe wish he had that one back. And Cameron McClure right in the right place at the right time. And it's a pick six back for a score on the heels of what Rome fans are going to tell you may have been a bad call on what might have been a touchdown for them on the other side on a play in which Javarius McDermott was ruled to be out of bounds. But instead, it becomes a pick six for Carrollton. 42-yard intercept return. That's our Breda Pest Management scoring summary. The junior defensive back, Cameron McClure. Big kick into the end zone. Touchback.
Yeah, huge momentum swing there, obviously. And Brandon, you know, from what we saw, I didn't see him get close. But listen, it's the speed of the game. We had official on the sideline. It happens. I don't know what angle he had. The angle that we've got certainly looked like to me that was going to be a touchdown call for Rome. It comes back, and two plays later, Carrollton with a pick six, and now they're up 20.
All right, let's put a positive spin on this if you're a Rome fan. Rome has found some offense here in the second half.
Yes,
didn't happen in the first.
Yep.
Can they touch it three times before the end of the game with 9:31 left to go?
They can, but Carrollton basically can't get a couple of first downs. You know, it's got to be three and outs. Maybe you still a possession. Still plenty of time here. But you would like to score quickly, maybe an explosive play. You probably got to have some type of turnover to get it three more times.
It's going to be complete to Daniel.
Ooh.
He's hit hard. I mean, really hard, right around the 27-yard line.
Jaden Thompson comes up, number five, and, man, watch five come up right here.
Boom, lowers that shoulder.
Yep, I got a flag here.
We're going to say false start against Rome.
False start. Offense, 5-yard penalty, replay second down.
We'll remind you that McDermott, who had played a lot anyway, has been kind of the lone running back tonight for the Wolves. Chance Arthur, another terrific back who had more than 100 yards in the first game we did for Rome earlier this year in our Corky Hill Dave Hunter Classic, but he left the game with injury and has not returned. It's been McDermott, the only back since then. He's in motion now. They're throwing to him. He's not able to come up with this one, though. That's going to bring up now third down. 8:59 to go. Rome looking at a third and seven. As I mentioned, going into our last commercial break, they haven't lost here since November of 2021, which was the Collins Hill game we did on television, correct?
They got upset in the first round by Johns Creek that year in the playoffs. Yeah, Travis Hunter beat them earlier that year. Sam Warren, that was a pretty strong team.
Sam Warren, of course, now at Missouri. Hunter at Colorado. Throwing is that. And is that complete? They're going to say, yes, it is. So move the chains there. Another catch for D.K. Daniel.
Good throw there by Fountain. Great job, Daniel, coming back and getting that.
Great shot, by the way, of the throw and catch from Fountain and Daniel. That's a really pretty image.
Drag. Nice job there by Daniel.
good play by both players and a good image of them doing so. Here's McDermott getting a chance to be a traditional running back now, and he's going to move the chains again. So here comes Rome.
Stop the clock there. Move the chains.
Carrollton showing you three across its defensive line. McDermott, a little stutter step. Now he's on the move. He's down to about the 26. May have got 17 that time. 8:31 to go. Clock stops again. Fresh set. Fountain dumps out to McDermott. McDermott, good tackle back there in the backfield, though. Kelvin Hill, who's done that a lot tonight, yes, comes up to meet him.
Been a great job tackling space there by number 8. He has certainly answered what Coach King wanted those guys to do.
So after the loss, make it second 14 now. Clock going under 8 minutes in the game. Here comes Carrollton. It's complete to Daniel. Daniel inside the 20, down to the 17.
It's a great read there by Fountain to see the blitz. You throw into the blitz. He recognizes it quickly, gets the ball off. Great job, and Daniel does the rest. First down, Rome.
Four receivers, two on each side. Here's McDermott, another stutter step type move for him. Lowers his shoulder inside the 10.
Got a flag down. I tell you, McDermott's got some spice to him as well.
He does.
You know what I mean? He brings a little something to the field when he gets the ball in his hands. Warner Robbins came all the way back.
Huge rivalry game down there tonight at the MAC. So the face mask going to go against Carrollton. And put Rome now in business in a first and goal inside the 5. This short yardage red zone has not always been kind to the Wolves, though. McDermott in motion. Fountain straight ahead, and he will score from 5 yards out. The Wolves cut into the deficit.
Man, they really carved up Carrollton right there. Great job, great answer by Rome to get right back in this thing. And Brandon, you said it a few minutes ago, they have found something on offense. And even if they don't win this game, this is something they can build on the rest of the season.
So Fountain staying out there with the score, now he comes off. So it's Cruz Reyes. He'll try the PAT. If he makes it, it's a 13-point game. And Jason Cruz Reyes does just that. So it's 26-13, 7:25 to go. Juju Lewis, the USC quarterback commit, big drive coming up right after this.
You don't have to wake up on the right side of the bed to know how you like your coffee, as long as it's McCafe coffee from Mickey D's. Now that's what you like.
Mix and match two breakfast hits for $4.49. Add any size iced coffee for $1.79.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. At Edmund Law, we understand that medical errors can lead to devastating results. That's why we fight for the compensation you deserve and hold those at fault accountable. Our highly reputable, experienced attorneys focus on catastrophic personal injury cases and have recovered over $100 million for our clients. And with my 12 years as a physician, I use that same bedside manner of caring to give you legal advice. Call now to schedule your free virtual consultation. The Edmund Firm, when I'm sorry is not enough.
America, come along with our adventure seekers, the Sanchez family, and discover summer with the Ford F-150. See how available features like Pro Trailer Backup Assist make backing up as easy as turning a knob. Watch as Pro Power On Board lights up the night. And Ford Blue Cruise makes driving even more fun. Now get select Ford F-150 trucks with 3.9% financing for 60 months, plus get up to $2,500 cash back with your trade-in.
The Peachtree TV Friday Night Game of the Week. Milton versus Roswell, next Friday at 8. High school football on Peachtree TV, Atlanta's own CW. Sponsored locally by these sponsors.
All right, 26-13 is our new score. Rome on the Reese Fountain touchdown run has cut this deficit now in half, exactly in half. Time is a factor. Carrollton's got the lead, but indications are we could still have a pretty exciting conclusion. Fun rivalry game between these two teams.
Yeah, I mean, this is two heavyweights, Brandon. No other way to describe it. Two heavyweights right here that have punched and counterpunched each other for most of the night.
Carrollton, a state finalist in the 7A classification a year ago, ranked number 5 right now. Rome, a state semifinalist in the 6A classification, ranked number 7 right now. They share a common loss, Rome to end last season against Langston Hughes, Carrollton to begin this season against the 6A defending state champs. Cruz Reyes will kick it low, wobbly, fielded 30-yard line. That's White. He crosses the 40 and gives Carrollton pretty good field position.
All right, right here, Rome has 3 timeouts.
When do you start using them?
You don't use them until about 3 minutes to go here, but the best thing to do here, you look at Joy, he's telling them, guys, we got to run this thing. We got to run this clock. This is what we want to do. We want to impose our will and run the ball right here. So I feel like there's going to be a heavy dose of 21 like there's been all night.
Keep in mind, this Rome defensive front has been so good tonight. And
they got a little break because of that drive. So great job to give them a breather.
McNeil, the receiver, goes in motion. The handoff, yardage, and more. That's Farmer. Flag comes in. But as it stands right now, it's a big game down to the 33-yard line.
This is a huge flag, Brandon, because they would have the ball on the Rome 32. And let's see what we get right here.
Yeah, it's a 21-yard gain.
Holding, see 18? See that? The holding on Carrollton. Yep, right there in space. So that was a huge penalty because Carrollton was sitting pretty there. And I told you we'll get a heavy dose of 21. Why not? And that's just somebody with effort down the field. And you just got to know, you got to take your hands off of that defender. You got to feel that. Keep your hands inside.
So keep in mind, it's 10 yards from the spot of the foul. The holding took place.
So first and 6.
Yeah, let's call it that. Kind of an odd scenario, but that's what we're left with. Here's Farmer again. And now second down's coming up.
Yep. Coach King got those guys together right before this drive and said, give me 3 first downs. Give me 3 first downs, and let me make them start using timeouts. So here we are, 2nd and 4.
Any need for Carrollton to change it up, or is it just Farmer one more time here?
You haven't. Farmer has been the difference in this game. I know they probably didn't intend on him to get 26, 27, 28 carries, but the young man still's doing it.
See Cedar Grove and Westlake in a shootout tonight in the 4th quarter.
Two great teams.
Lewis will throw, complete to Kofer, and Kofer moves the chain. So they were expecting the Farmer run, and Lewis instead connects with Kion Kofer to move the chains for Carrollton on the outside.
Look how quick the ball gets out there from Juju Lewis on that ball.
Odom had the block, by the way.
Good job there out on the perimeter.
Looking at 6:15 now. Carrollton is not in a hurry.
And you see that play call? That's why Joey King's the highest paid coach in the state of Georgia. And Rusty Mantell is not.
Kofer, who had the catch, is now in motion. The handoff goes to Farmer. Farmer's got room, needs a block, and gets it. And he's down to the 15-yard line.
Just weaving in and out of his blockers. Rome having a tough time tonight. I guarantee you this, nobody in a red jersey on this staff thought they were going to get 160, 170 out of that young man tonight.
What a night.
He is still going.
What a night. Including 18 more yards on that carry.
He's going to sleep good tomorrow.
186 yards, unbelievable. 28 carries, 186 yards. He has been the sum total of the rushing attack for Carrollton. Only player to carry tonight. And he gets it again. And he fights through the first wave of defenders and probably got himself four more. Clock, if it wasn't a factor before, it definitely is now, about to go under 5 minutes. They can take 30 more seconds off the clock before they run their next now.
Yeah, that's what Joey, I guarantee he was saying, just give me three first down because Rome is about to start having to burn timeouts.
Three receivers on the left side.
They got the ball back with 7:50, Brandon. Already approaching 4 minutes.
Farmer with the middle. He's got room, and he's inside the 15 to about the 13. That's nine more, and it's a fresh set of downs.
I mean, he's just shaking his head like I don't know if he understands what being in the zone is yet, but he might because I feel like he's been in the zone tonight. And this young man is growing up right in front of your eyes.
Speaking of zones, how about the red zone presented by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com? And credit to this Carrollton offensive line. Joey King said the matchup of the game was going to be his offensive line against this Rome defensive front. And Rome's had its moments, but Carrollton is good when it matters.
They've had problems pass blocking Rome, but they have really established the run. So
pass caught to Odom, by the way, and a nice job of the open field tackle by Wilkinson, the App State commit.
You look at the Carrollton offensive line, and they're going to watch this run blocking, and they're going to be very happy with that. They did lose some battles in the pass blocking versus this Rome front. Got a flag down. Rome players are clapping.
Rashard Sullivan, the nose man, does come off the field and looks like.
If they called that on Odom or not. Man, what a drive. They've already taken 4 minutes off the clock, Brandon.
It has been ruthlessly efficient. Roswell on top of Marietta right now, and actually that's a final 51-14. The Hornets get a big win tonight over Marietta squad.
We're going to see them next week. And by the way, Roswell retired Robbie Roper's number tonight. And you
imagine the emotion in that room for
that. I tell you, man.
That building for that.
I don't know that many teams would want to be on the sideline from that bunch tonight.
Wow. Okay, it's going to be an unsportsmanlike conduct going against Carrollton.
That is something that would not make Joey King happy because he is a perfectionist with things like that.
Lambert getting a win against Mountain View.
Tell you what, Rome's got some things to correct, but they got a tough one next week, Pebblebrook. And that game last year went down to the very last drive.
All right, looking at third down after the penalty. and it's a long one. Carrollton would need the, not quite the eight, but the 8.5 for a first down. And they may be backed up again. Yeah, they're going to get backed up on a procedural penalty. So third and 29. You throw the screen here to a farmer, or you just let Choo-Choo crank it up and see what he can do?
I tell you, I'm so old school. I want the clock to run.
Yeah. Tight end goes in motion. The hand, no, it's going to be a throw by Lewis. It's to Odom. Did he stay on his feet? If he did, it's a first down, and he's still on his feet, and it's going to be a touchdown. Second of the night for Caleb Odom. And it took every bit of ball body control he could have. How does he stay on his feet?
He landed on top of number 16. If we go back, watch him. Watch when he spins off 16. See that? He landed on him. Gets up and look at the big man keep his feet. Touchdown.
A fitting play of the game presented by HendrickCars.com. The Alabama commit as advertised. Second touchdown. And that was a magic trick.
What a drive there by Carrollton. Got the ball back, Brandon, with 7 minutes and 50 seconds. Rome, that's three timeouts.
And the score comes on third and 29.
Third and 29.
Wow. We'll also see our game's key first down. That's Lewis with the completion to Kyan Kofer. And obviously, that's what allowed Carrollton to run so much clock and get in the position for what turned out to be the Odom score. The game's key first down presented by the Atlanta Falcons. You got to give Carrollton a ton of credit. They have been in a tough environment tonight. And loud crowd, boisterous environment.
They've been hitting the mouth.
They've been hitting the mouth, and they have responded.
They have answered, man. They have answered like a champ. And every time you felt like the momentum was going toward Rome, Carrollton answered with a score. Not a drive, Brandon, a score.
When you think about sophomore quarterback, sophomore running back, you know, whatever the highest classification our state looks like next year, obviously the 7A classification going away, I think it's safe to say that Carrollton's going to be a big part of the story, whatever the...
Carrollton is young.
Julian Vargas kick away, end zone, not returnable. And with 3:09 to go and up 20, it is all Trojans here at the moment. And if you're Rome, you know...
It's what if.
It is.
It's what if. It's two special teams plays. It's 0-for-2 in the red zone in the first half. Listen, you're going to discuss it. It's going to be a call that was blown. Looks like it was blown. So, you know, there's a lot of things you say what if, but you also take away the positives, and you got hit in the mouth, and you responded in the second half as well.
Yeah, I'm as convinced as ever that Rome is a major factor in the 6A classification until the very end.
No doubt.
But, you know, from the perspective of Wolves fans, what they're going to say is when McDermott's ruled out of bounds and then it leads to the pick six for Carrollton, that's a 14-point swing in this game.
Yeah, I mean, you're looking, it was 19-6. If you get that an extra point, you're 19-13, maybe 19-12. But, say again, that last drive, there was no missed calls. It was Carrollton execution.
It just was.
And it was a touchdown.
Fountain, did Daniel hold on to it? Yeah, he did. At the 28. Not quite enough for the first down, though. We'll make it third and one, and let's call it the 29, too. There's McDermott. McDermott kind of has that interesting little.
I like him.
Yeah.
I like him.
That little, you know, kind of like a little stutter step thing when he, right there at the line of scrimmage. He used that effectively.
Yeah, moving forward, too, you start talking about Chance Arthur. Coach Reed said, if we're going to win this game, we need Chance Arthur to have a big game. He got hurt early.
Yeah, been out for almost the entirety of the game.
Yep.
Throwing Hester. That's a pretty throw by Fountain.
Dropped it right in there.
2:05. Rome is not even showing the slightest signs of giving up. Breda Pest Management score ticker rolls on. Scores from around the state. Catamounts of Dalton got a big win over Snorreville tonight.
I tell you, man, Dalton's one of those teams. They're in this region as well. And, I think Dalton, well, Dalton's in that Calhoun-Cartersville Hiram region.
McDermott spins to the 40. It'll be about third and one coming up. So, Rusty, football is officially here and upon us. We're in kind of our, what I think of as our true regular season, and college football tomorrow, NFL going next week. Our long wait is finally over.
Yep. It's, I think somebody said last night, Thursday night kickoff, five nights in a row of college football.
I love it. And LSU, Florida State on Sunday night. Is that going to be fun?
Yeah, I mean, listen, maybe I'm wrong. But I've got LSU in that game, even without Mason Smith.
I think so, too. Now, I think when Smith returns, I think that ball may have touched the ground. Yeah, it's incomplete. Smith, who's obviously facing an NCAA suspension for an autograph signing that took place, honestly, a few weeks prior to the advent of the NIL rules, which is a very, very strange thing. But yeah, I think he's also probably a little bit banged up, too. I believe Smith coming back, the former elite recruit, when he's fully healthy, I think he gives them an extra dimension to the defensive line they probably didn't have a year ago. And I think they're a legitimate playoff contender. A minute, 6 seconds left. Fountain, he's 29-5 as a starter, and he's fighting down to the end here. May not go his way, but there's no less fight in him than ever. There's no quit in any of these guys at all.
Yeah, Fountain's going to be another one that's going to sleep well tomorrow. He's taking some shots tonight, played hard. Obviously had a little treatment going on this week, took a shot last week. But
how much does a game like this mean to him when, obviously, 2 years younger, a guy like Lewis, and Lewis's attention is well-deserved, but it's more attention than what Fountains has got. How much extra motivation do you think a guy like Reese takes in a game like that because of that?
I'm sure. I mean, I've known that kid since he was at birth. And, you know, he's a gutsy kid. He's a leader. He's a quiet leader. Leads by example, but ultimate competitor, and that's what colleges are looking at him. I mean, you see what he can do tonight. I know he wishes he had a couple throws back, but I think the addition to him showing his legs is going to help him down the line. You see that? I mean,
yeah.
That's you got. It's hard to defend that, and that helps him.
And I'm curious, as the clock's going to tick down to zeros here, I think Carrollton in the main conversation at the front end of 7A, they were a state finalist a year ago.
Question.
They've got to be there again. It's
no
Cauquid
question.
County, obviously.
No question.
It's Carrollton.
Walton.
It's Walton.
We'll see Milton.
Yeah.
We'll see Milton, I mean.
It's a fun, our top classification, so much fun right now. And Hester thinks he should have got a touchdown on that. Yeah, I just think the top classification is as deep as it is. Now, Buford rightly probably viewed as a favorite, but they were viewed as the favorite a year ago, and they didn't win it.
I'll say this, and me and you talk about it every week. There's 7 or 8 in 7A that can win this thing. You talking about a fun bracket? When we get into that tournament.
So much fun.
We get into that tournament.
The guy right now who I think is making such a big difference, too, is the presence of Daniel Calhoun at Walton. Walton's been good.
Correct.
The beef, the size, they're playing him some in defensive line as well. The Georgia commit there along the offensive line. To me, that gives Walton a little bit of a edge up front. I don't know they've had always.
And how good they're playing on defense.
Oh, my gosh,
Ashton Woods, Wendell Gregory, those guys.
Yeah, we saw Gregory, the South Carolina commit. He looked terrific in the Corky Kell, Dave Hunter Classic. And obviously Woods, the North Carolina commit, has been, you know, capping off what has been an amazing career as Rome is going to try to punch it in here. They're going to call a timeout to do that.
And people are probably going, why is he doing this? Well, I'll tell you why he's doing it. Because his team has been struggling in the red zone, and they get a chance to run another play and put something on tape.
let me also give you another shout out here about the fun thing the Atlanta Falcons have coming up. How about the Beltline Bash here coming up the Atlanta Falcons? It's going to be Saturday, September 2nd. That's tomorrow, by the way. It's a free pop-up event on the east side of Beltline. You can enjoy food, drinks, games, giveaways, and more. And you can learn more at AtlantaFalcons.com/fans.
Is Falcons football. It's Grady putting quarterbacks on notice. It's Kyle shredding defenses like a unicorn. It's Tyler breaking tackles like phone screens. It's AJ locking down anyone on his island. It's Drake touching the sun. It's CP breaking another record. What is Falcons football? It's all you dirty birds. Rise up.
All right, final seconds of our drive for the GHSA state title. It's been a fun one for me. Carrollton's going to win here. Rome's going to try to tack on some points before it's all said and done. Don't forget, when we are done, we'll get a chance to hear from Joey King, the coach who made such a name for himself back at Cartersville, winning state championships with the terrific Trevor Lawrence, who is the state's all-time leading passer.
Yep.
Which, by the way, Aaron Philo from Prince Avenue Christian would have.
He's got a chance.
I mean, it's going to take a Herculean season, but it's mathematically possible he could surpass that record himself. But the point is, we'll hear from Joey King in just a moment, who comes into Barron Stadium, gets a win tonight. Fountain.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that's something I got to work on with 14 this week. Had a couple of drops, and that was a ball on the money. I like the play there. I like that red zone call. That's something they'll work on. Good ball here by Fountain.
But the night belongs to Carrollton. A terrific rivalry. Two teams that have played historic, meaningful games for years and years. The latest chapter belongs to the Trojans. They're going to win 33-13. And they send a message, if it needed to be said, that a team that played for a state championship a year ago has hopes, aspirations, and possibly even expectations of going at least that far again in 2023. The sophomore quarterback, Juju Lewis, on his way to USC. I think he proved what the hype was about tonight.
Yeah, I think Julian Lewis probably tell you he didn't have his best first half, but, man, it didn't take him long. The first drive of the second half, he was on.
Craig Sager Jr. is standing by down there with Joey King right now. The winning coach of the Trojans, Craig Sager Jr., take it away.
All right, I'm joined now by Carrollton head coach Joey King. Before the game, both sidelines said they wanted to establish the run. It seemed like in the first half, you guys were really able to get it going and then defensively set the tone, made it as difficult as possible.
Yeah, that was it. You know, we talked about playing silent in all three phases. I know that's coach talk, but I think we did a really good job of that in the first half. Gave up some stuff there in the second half, but our kids kept responding. Sure am proud of their effort tonight.
And speaking of effort, Kamari Farmer, everyone watching that game, just so impressed with a sophomore stepping up like he's done, all those carries, and just to last the entire game. What about this performance tonight just really stood out to you?
Everything that he did. I mean, he's a tough kid. He's going to keep fighting. We knew that about him going into it. You know, so he did a really good job carrying the load for us tonight.
And then defensively, you guys shut him out in the first half. You knew it looked like you guys were really confident in that defense continuing that, but talk about the way you guys responded out of the gates in the second half.
Yeah, I mean, we came out, we got that first offensive score, and then the defense did a good job holding them, you know, and we talked about playing with freakish effort all night, and I think our kids really did that. You know, we said whoever plays with the best effort is going to win this football game. Sure am proud of our guys again.
Yeah, special teams was impressive. I love the way you guys were covering on those kickoffs, but let's talk about Caleb Odom real quick. We saw the extremely athletic touchdown right there. I mean, such a mismatch. Talk about just the performance he had.
Oh, man, he did a great job. I mean, every time we dialed his number, he responded. And in that play, I watched it probably four or five times on the sideline on the iPad just to see, I mean, how athletic, how flexible he is, but how determined he was to get in the end zone in that situation.
Awesome. Well, there you have it. Congratulations, Coach King and the Trojans. 2-1. We'll be joined after the break with our players of the game.
Yikey Wawa! Running out of hot water is one way your water heater cries out for help. Call R.S. Andrews. Get a water heater rejuvenation. Your water heater gets added life, you get more hot water. Another way R.S. Andrews makes you smile today.
I've used R.S. Andrews 15 years. Purchased two heating and air systems, so I rely on their technicians for service. I call, they come, it's fixed. And I appreciate Andrews' commitment. He gives it his all. That's how R.S. Andrews makes me smile.
What does it mean when people say America is a land of opportunity?
It means the power to discover.
To redefine yourself.
To improve yourself.
To challenge yourself.
To realize there's more in you
than you ever knew
that you could do.
It means giving people an open field to explore what they do best.
With the best tools.
The best training.
The best technology in the world.
We bring out the best in the people who serve.
So you can be all you can be.
A journeyman with Local 85, when you turn out, you can be hitting six figures.
Hey, I have your back, you have my back, we're gonna do this together. We're one for all for one.
College just wasn't for me. Let's look into actual career jobs that wouldn't take college, where I wouldn't, you know, lose money and all that. Instead of losing a lot more money at the end, why not make money and make more money at the end?
The GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com drive for the GHSA state title is sponsored by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers Local 613. Electrify your career. Gordo's, Fiesta every day. Personal Touch Lawn Care. The smallest details make the biggest difference. Merriweather and Tharp. Merriweather and Tharp LLC. The Atlanta Divorce Team.com. R.S. Andrews. Story after story, we deliver smiles. And by Breda Pest Management, the official pest control of Atlanta.
And welcome to the Tailgate Show, brought to you by GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com. I'm Kaylee Mansell, and I'm joined by our Gatorade Players of the Game, starting with our Gatorade Offensive Player of the Game, Kamari Farmer, and our Gatorade Defensive Player of the Game, Cameron McClure. Kamari, I'm going to come to you first. Carrollton only put up 13 points in the first half, a slow start to a Carrollton offense. What adjustments did you guys make in the second half?
Our game plan was the same. We just had to come out, execute it, you know. We got off slow in the first half, but great coach, great game plan. We put up points. That's what we do. Mm-hmm.
And, Cameron, I was right here watching you guys when Rome was, like, second in inches right there, and you guys made some incredible defensive stops. What do you think that says about the eliteness of y'all's defense?
Well, to be honest, we came out here, like, intensity. Coach said don't let the offense run over us, continue to play football and just do our job, make tackles, make plays.
Simple. You had two major touchdowns tonight. I've got to know, what does it feel like when you're running into the end zone, knowing that you're making a difference? What goes through your head as you enter the end zone?
Oh, man, I love it, man. There's nothing like it. The atmosphere of just running in the end zone, I mean, that's what you do it for right here, the team, the family. You know, I love it. It's a great feeling.
Cameron, you had a pick six tonight that completely disrupted the game. Talk about the read that you had on that ball, and did you know in that moment that it was ball game?
Oh, yeah. Like, before the game, I even said I was going to get a pick. I felt it. I knew it was coming. I just dropped back, sat, squatted, saw the ball, caught it, touchdown, pick six. Let's go.
Well, on behalf of Georgia Construction Careers, I want to present the Robbie Hunter MVP Award to number 21, Kamari Farmer. We're going to give this to you afterwards. But, guys, I just want to say congratulations on being our Gatorade Offensive Players of the Game tonight. We knew that you guys were going to come out here and kill it. You put on a show. So excited to see what y'all do the rest of the season.
Appreciate it.
All right, guys, make sure to stay tuned. We have more coming up right after the break.
This little circle of wood right here, this is where everyone from Hank Williams to Johnny Cash, they stood here.
On Saturday nights, it's more than just music. It's community. It's on the Circle Network with Opry Live.
Well, the first time I stepped on the Circle, you know, trying not to break down in tears.
The spirit of the Opry takes you to another world.
How about it? How about it?
Oh, yeah.
Every week, be a part of history.
Conway, up in heaven, if you're watching, help me.
Opry Live, where legends circle back and up-and-comers step in.
Would you welcome Luke Combs,
the newest member for the Grand Ole Opry.
The Circle is powerful, brings us together, and moves us.
That is what we call an Opry moment.
Every Saturday night, country's most famous stage is live and in your home.
Country plays here.
I felt like nobody wanted me. I was just, felt like my life was already over.
I had nightmares every single day in my birth mom's house.
It was just really scary for me living there.
My biggest fear was that I was gonna age out and not know how to be sufficient on my own.
At a certain age, like, they don't want you, you're troubled and stuff. But, like, inside I knew, like, I'm not a troubled kid. I know what I'm meant for, like, why I'm here.
I was scared, I was lost, and I felt hopeless. Even if I wanted to be adopted, who would adopt a 17-year-old?
He deserves to feel happy. To feel loved. And I just wish I had gotten him sooner.
None other than GeorgiaConstructionCareers.com. I'm Kaylee Mansell, joined by Score Atlanta reporter Craig Sager. Just got to see our Gatorade players of the game. Craig, is this the outcome that we imagined from tonight's matchup?
You know what? I expected Rome's defense to make it tough for Carrollton. Yeah. I knew it was going to be tough for them to run the ball. I did not expect Kamari Farmer to be that just ready to go in the spotlight. He had such a big game. I think he has 3 touchdowns every single outing this season. And I was just talking to Carrollton. I think he was a few yards short of having a top 10 rushing performance in Carrollton history. That's how big he's been so far, the sophomore.
Well, we definitely had an exciting week 3 matchup tonight, but also there are plenty of games that were going on across the state. So let's take a look at our scoreboard. Presented by Score Atlanta. Craig, are there any scores right there that stand out to us? I know we were looking at Douglas County, McEachern earlier. Thoughts?
That's a big statement. We saw Douglas County beat Mays last week. They're undefeated. Sire Hardaway's doing his thing, and that's a big defensive effort right there. The Cedar Grove Westlake game was nuts.
It
saw
came
some
down
trick
to the
plays.
Last yep. second.
So big win for Westlake, and speaking of, they'll be in Carrollton's path this season. Colquitt looks amazing, and then Baldwin, who I believe they beat Peach County week 1, they fall short to Ware County. It's a big statement by the Gators.
And Roswell having no issue with Marietta. We will see Roswell in next week's matchup versus Milton. Some other scores, lots of Gwinnett schools up there. Buford with their 3rd win of the season over North Cobb. What about that page speaks to you?
Well, I saw some highlights. I think Brandon was talking about it from the Buford game. Dylan and that offense definitely came alive. North Cobb is a legit team. They pulled away, so that's good to see for Buford fans, that offense getting going. And then Collins Hill, a big win over Brookwood. They lost to Milton week 1. I really like their defensive front, and you know they made it hard for Brookwood to rush in that game. And then also, I mean, Mill Creek, they stay undefeated, a big win for them as well. On this one, Peachtree Ridge, Loganville's a great defensive team, and this Peachtree Ridge offense with Darnell Kelly, the sophomore quarterback, has been lights out so far. I think they're going to be 5-0 heading into that big region game against Meadow Creek, and man, if they win that one, they're going to be in some big games with Norcross and some of the other powerhouses in that region. And then what else in this one do you?
West Forsyth, North Forsyth, in-county rivals, not in the same region, but they match up against each other every year. We got to see both teams separately in the Corky Kell Dave Hunter Classic. West Forsyth leads the series all time. They continue to do so tonight, but in a smaller margin than they typically do. So I think that shows that North Forsyth is already improving this season. We have more scores up here. I think the one that really stands out to me is Cedartown losing to Sequoia. Cedartown made it to the state championship last year, kind of maybe having a rebuilding year this year, kept it really close against Sequoia, and I'm surprised by that.
Yeah, it was a pretty close game last year. Obviously, Cedartown got the win. I had a feeling, though, with the Sequoia team, they basically said at media day that they were going to be the real deal, and if anyone underestimated them this year, they'd regret it. I had a feeling about that. That's a huge win for the Chiefs. And then Coconut Creek, I think they beat Cedar Grove last week. Gainesville gets the win over them. Gainesville looks outstanding. Mm-hmm. Jefferson, I bet Sammy Brown went yep. off again. I think the last game he had 17 tackles, 140 rushing yards, and a 70-yard punt. So
well, when you shut a team like St. Pius out, that speaks to your defense.
Yeah, I mean, Sammy Brown's just an absolute animal. Cartersville, watch out for them. 5A, we saw the Warner Robins score. We've seen some other ones. Cartersville has some serious talent at the skill positions. And then Calhoun, I believe that was a comeback. They were down 14-0.
Yep.
Bounce back 28-14. Big result for them after losing their season opener to BT.
Looking at our next set of scores, another round of great games, obviously. Great Atlanta Christian, Pace Academy, battle of that area of private schools right there. Greater Atlanta Christian coming on top just barely. And then Benedictine over Westminster, two teams that consistently just have competitive programs.
Yeah, Benedictine has not lost to a 4A opponent, I think, in 3 years. Westminster made it close, but the Cadets once again prevail. And then GAC's off to one of the best starts they've had in several seasons. And then Perry, they opened the season last week against Houston County. It was a close game, and then they just came out and dominated. So they did not lose any firepower after the graduation of Amar Gordon. And then, it looks like the Wayne County, Appen County got postponed. I was looking forward to that one. Would have been a top 10 matchup. Maybe it will be later this week or later on in the season. And then Dalton, do not sleep on them in 5A. Yep. They won some big games in the region. We've seen Cass, we've seen Hiram struggle at times. Calhoun's had some tough outings. Dalton is in that same region with Cartersville. I like their chances.
Moving on to our last page right here. Five new set of games. Mary Person barely coming out on top over Trinity Christian. Callaway dropping to Troup County. That's a big rivalry right there, too. Those schools are right there together.
Yeah, Troup County is coming off a 50-0 win, I think, over Hardaway last week. Callaway had the big win over Cedar Town, and then Troup is able to hold on. You know that was a good game.
Yes.
Cross classification, but definitely a rivalry matchup right there. Mary Persons beat a great Trinity Christian team. Mm-hmm. Trinity Christian beat Fellowship last week. They have Phoenix Moss in the backfield. He's a beast, so watch out for Mary Persons. Central Carroll's off to an incredible start as well. They got the freshman phenom at quarterback. Coach Smiley went over to Sandy Creek. They haven't lost a step, though. Prolific rushing attack. Great quarterback play. Really impressive so far. And then Raven County bounced back from getting, I believe, steamrolled by Stevens County last week. And so that was a big win for them.
All right, and next week, week four, we will head to Roswell to see Milton face off against Roswell. What can we expect?
It's just always crazy. I think mm-hmm. that's one of the best rivalries. It's going to be outstanding. You'll see in the Roswell area beat Milton signs. You'll see in the Milton area beat Roswell, and they aren't even in the same classification. Yep. So that just goes to show.
Mm-hmm. Yard signs will be out, and so will we. Peachtree TV, 8 o'clock next Friday. It's a matchup you're not going to want to miss. So from myself, Craig, IJ Rosenberg, Roddy White, Rusty Mansell, Brandon Adams, and so many others. We wish you all good night. It's College Game Day tomorrow, guys. The Dogs play at 6 o'clock. How exciting is that? But not as exciting as our high school football matchup that we'll have next Friday. Know you guys will be there. See you then.
Our excellence is shining, yet so many of us are dying. Colon cancer is silently killing our people, our friends, and family. So screen we must. We do this for all of us, from every corner, doorstep, and pulpit, period. The health revolution